arriving now from a retirement, that we stop the this assessment as a whole. There is no difference. That means local accident, accident, bad movies, and something like that. So that we try it out. And then I also put the subject in various international investment board. So we got, I can only mention my attitude, myself in India, control of accidents and disasters in 21st century. In the World Mining Congress, they did November 2000. My another view of the subject, self-statute for expanding mining, because mining is expanding in the big scale. Mining industry is a tool for expanding mining industry of India. And the second ASEA mining congress, 10th July 2018. So I am very happy that Ratan has had great need of this and software for this as well. Again, thank Ratan for giving me a chance to put this into the audience.
Thank you, sir, for sparing your valuable time with us. Next, I would like to request Dr. A.K. Verma from IIT Kharagpur to present his paper on technical options for safe mining practices in an open cast mine. Okay, sir.
Okay. mining operation is going on from right to left direction, and the rainfall in this area is more or less 11.6 mm. But in a particular area, the rainfall level was more than 500 mm. So we can see the problem, which is originated from the amount of rainfall taking place in that particular area. Now there is another thing which is there, that is there are four aquifers are there, defined into the rock strata. Then the most of the materials, this is also very peculiar here. This is the silica sand, it is very close to the sand, still flowing, lying on top of the porcelain, and there is sandy clay and porcelain, very small amount. So the issues are related with this rainfall, aquifer, and the type of material we are dealing with. So, and one more issue, as far as the heat is concerned, the heat for this declined before the transport for a particular company, and for this silica sand, it is gone for the other company. So the companies also are enjoying the use of silica sand, they are living a very useful life, because they are not caring for all of this silica sand. Because unless and until you are not removing the overburden material, you cannot take out the core of the lignite depositing this mine. So all the material handling is being taken care by the coal company, and the goods are enjoyed by the person or the company who is getting a contract of the silica sand. Now coming to a very now I will go to the more slides that will show you this situation, what are the situation or what are the curious situation I am trying to deliver over here. Now this is a mine, and it is being divided into 5-3 blocks, 1, 2, and 3, and the strike length for a particular block is about 600 meters. So there are 3 blocks are being here. Blocking means we are doing this mining operation in at 3 different places. If you look at the deep, this is on the higher side, this is on the lower side. So the mining operation is continuing in an apparent direction. So they are maintaining one of the blocks at the best level and followed by the another 2 levels. Another thing, this another slide you will see, there is one issue, like you can see during the rain, the water accumulation. Water accumulation is taking place at the faces or the both faces. Because of that, you have to stop the mining operation. And in this reason, the rainfall is taking place for 4 months. So definitely, you have to, there is a rainfall of about 2300 mm. So you cannot continue your mining operation. So here the issues come, like boiler pumping, especially pumping is one of the options. You can add more number of pumps to pump out this water out of the mine. But solution was tried by these people, but if your water level in 1 year becomes 11 to 12 to 500 mm, definitely you are not very prepared about those type of situations. Another thing, this is the one issue where the mining is continuing from rise to tail. Second is the water accumulation, and next problem is dumping. You can see the dump of the loose material. They are dumping some of the loose material in the right side of the mine. And because of that dumping, what happens when the rainwater falls? They are mixing with this loose material and moving, rushing towards the deep side. Once they are moving, what happens? They are creating a sludge or chip formation right at the face. So we have to deal with this. Now you can see the situation. You cannot see the coal bench at all, or the lignite bench, what is there. It is fully submerged. And in this situation, this is a very dangerous situation for a mining company when you are not removing the economical material and you are just handling the overburden. And this situation is there for this particular company for about 4 to 6 months. You can see the dumps of this silica sand. They have to preserve at some other place. And now these materials where clay material is there and silica sand is there, they have to dump it at the right side. So because of this heavy rain, what is happening? One problem is the water accumulation, so you have to stop the mining operation. Second thing is that accumulation of these silts or this large right at the tail. Second is, third is the walk out of your faces or other faces. Means you have heaviness of material is taking place because the material is very loose in nature, so will fall down and they are depositing at this particular place. So there is a problem with the pumping also. You can do the pumping of water, but you cannot do the pumping of sludge at all. So, and also if you are going for the removal of the sludge, that is okay. That is not possible at all. But recovery, if you are pumping all the water out of there, the removal of the sludge is another problem. And that cannot be done within one or two days or 1 month. They are taking about 6 months time for the clearance of all these type of sludge in the mine. You can see the situation in the mine about the other working benches or the non-coal benches. All are being disturbed by this water problem and this information right at the bottom. So to solve this problem, what we can do? Now you can think of what are the solutions we have. We can solve this problem. The problem is the silt. So for that, we have one solution. So these are the issues we have. Flooding of the coal benches. Second issue is washout of the non-coal benches. Then we have sliding of the in-pit dumping, whatever we are doing in the high side towards the working benches. And the winning of this coal is being stopped for about 4 to 6 months. So this is the major issues for the mining companies who are intended for the profitability. They are working for the profitability. So what is there? We can go for the removal of water pumping, or we can go for the removal of the silt. So first of all, we will start removing the water for the coal for the first few months, then we will go for the removal of the silt. Then this is what we are talking about. This pumping is not the solution. So what is the solution? So innovative solution is here. What is the solution? This is not very common in our as far as this scope is concerned, problem we are talking about. We have to go for a water tap. What this water tap is doing? It is just a stopping. When you make this water tap, you have to leave the intact material in between the working area and between the cold area. What do you mean by the cold area? We can look for, we can create a barrier instead of the same material. We can leave the intact material over here just behind the working pool so that it will act like a barrier and then we can proceed forward. So we can have a solution of creating a water tank. What it will do? It will do gas the silt. It will not allow the slate silt or the sludge to flow towards the working bench. And what prevents the silt movement? And will allow minimum part of water accumulation right at the base. Whatever the water will be there, that will be accumulated behind those barriers. So, less water will be there, so definitely your pumping operation will be efficient. You can go ahead with that. So, what we can do, and then what we are doing here, you know, because this dam we are creating, that dam is being overlaid. The ignite is being confined to that, so that ignite can be removed after the rainy season or after the monsoon season. And then again, once the mining operation further depend by 50 meter or so, we can again create a dam during your before the monsoon season, and this process will keep on going as we are going deeper and deeper. So this is a very innovative idea which has been suggested to this company to tackle all these problems. So for that, what we have to do, now you see the conceptual diagram over here. This is your working phase, and we can create a dam over here. So whatever the water will be there, what happens, all the waters are activating over here. From here also the water is coming down. So this becomes a big pond. So further that, you can leave some portion of the geomaterial over here. The water is going to be accumulated over here at the backside of this dam or the water barrier, and then a little amount is going to be accumulated here. What are the material water coming from here? Water from the aquifers or the water from the slopes is being accumulated. So minimum amount of water will be here that can be easily easily handled with the pumping operation, and this way you can continue your mining operation for the 4 years. There is no need for the halting this process. So another problem here, what is the problem? Because this pole, this is the pointer is showing you the lignite deposit, and below that we have a clay material. So that is also another problem. What is the problem? What is the problem? Because clay is very weak, and once it is in contact, the clay is also sliding. Because the fact, weather is very less, so it can slide very easily. So what happens because of that? Because that's why you will see we are removing this clay from here. So what it does? It will allow that the forces from the upper right side is not coming to this. And because of that, there is some sort of cooling operation are observing right at the in this side, in the working case side. So to avoid that, we have to remove this amount of total clay which is continuing from the two right side. So after removal of this, the problem of puncturing or heating of this road was also curtailed, or it was minimized.
GMDC mine.
So for this, what is the solution? The solution lies with some mathematical relationship or some of these little models we have to develop to get the solution. So here, what analysis we can go? We can develop the total mine in a computer model, or we can go for the working. Some of the critical sections where we can assume that the failure are invariable. So we have to take a recent selection of the type of analysis we have to do. Generally, for this purpose, we are going for 2D analysis, because 3D having certain limitations as far as the time of computation is concerned and the time of development of this model is concerned. So we have for this purpose, 2D model has been developed for the different sections which have been decided based on the stages and deciding about the criticality of the section, which one is more vulnerable for the failure. So for that, which one is the villain in this picture? Villain is only the water. So we have to tackle the situation by assuming that what is the amount of water, how the water is changing the scenario, or how the water is changing the factor of safety of this type of what is called the slopes, and then the sliding of your what is called the input downs, or the stability of the dam we are creating. So here we are assuming that, what we are assuming, we can assume that it is the mine is full of water. Full of water means 100% saturation. Full of water means heavy rain is there for a continuous. Maybe we are assuming that there is an exceptional condition of a heavy rain of about 2-3 days where your rainfall is about 2500 mm or 3000 mm in that location. And then we can assume that after rain is over, some water is still there because of the aquifer, and some water is also there within the strata itself. And there is a dry condition where everything is dry during the summer season, but still the water is being recharged, or water is flowing through the aquifer. From where this water is coming up? Because there is a river Narmada which is recharging this aquifer continuously. So there is a solution for what is called, you can control this water by simply going for the pumping operation. You can go for the pumping operation in a mine and around the periphery of the mine. To counter the effects of this aquifer. And this is what I was saying to you, this is what our practice is here in our mind. If there is a recharge of the aquifer from the nearby water body, we can go for the pumping operation surrounding the mine or surrounding the pit. So the material characterization is important. We have to find it out the different properties related to as far as the stability is concerned. Then we can have to find out the local geology, whether there is any joints, any fractures, any geological discontinuities are there or not. And based on that, we have to design the slope. We have to design the slope We have to design the dam based on the worst scenario of the worst 100% saturation condition. So some of the properties which is required in this case, that is required to be the elevation, angle of internal friction, then density, and then we find it out what is the capacity of water to hold it. What is the amount of water the material can hold? So that property we have to find out, because it is found that once we are adding water, up to certain percentage the water will be added. And beyond that, if you add, it will come out of the material. So we have to find it out what is the water the material can absorb. Maybe 10% water, 50% water, or 20% water. That is very important. That we have to find it out. And then some of the other properties are there that is used to find out the behavior of material. Whether that is this permeability, we can find it out how easily the water will pass from one place to another in a granular material or the geological material. What is the inherent moisture content? In case of dry season, how much water is being retained by the material? That is what we have to find out. We cannot have, if it is zero, then we can say that it is completely dry, but there are certain percentage material can hold it, like clay can attract the water and it can keep the water for a long period of time. And if the water is there, the material properties are being heated because of this water. So we have to find out in normal situation what is the percentage of water contained in this type of material. Then we can find out what is the particle size distribution. This is going to give you the idea that what amount of compaction you can have, or what type of, what is the level of confinement you can have, whether there is a same type of material is there, or there is a very good type of material is there. Like say for example, if you have a very spherical type of material is there, or same size like a ball, so you will find that a lot of pore spaces can be formed. But if you have a differential size of material, where there are small sizes, big sizes, all the sizes are there, you will find that the pore spaces or the gap between the two particles will be lesser and lesser. So with this particle analysis, we can get this idea. And the, all these, so some of the properties are being used for the cavity analysis. Some of the properties are used to get the idea about the characteristic under characteristic of this property. So that we can find out. I am not going in detail about all these analysis properties. Now come to the analysis part. All these material properties are being used for two types of analysis we can do. One is called equilibrium analysis, or another is called, we can go for the numerical analysis. So, So we can find it out the factor of safety required. We can use this equation in a computer model and we can find it out for the different values of for different conditions, what will be the factor of safety of this probe. Then what are the design parameters for an existing mine or for the snow? We have these four design parameters are there. We can design the base width, we can design the bench height, we can design the bench angle and the number of, or what will be the height of the slope. And then for an operating mine like this, we have constraint that we cannot change the width and height. Height we cannot increase because of the constraint of the machine. We cannot increase the width, but finally these two parameters are affecting the overall fixed slope angle of the mine. So these parameters we cannot change. What are the options we have? We can change bench angle, we can change the total height of the slope. So because of that, so we can overall, so what is our design objective or design objective, and whatever the mining company is doing there, their motive is to get this overall slope angle as high as possible. Because they do not want this to be flatter and flatter. So this is our design objective. Once we say it should be flatter, then we have to remove more amount of overburden. So this is the constraint. That is the design objective where we have to control the overall slope angle as high as possible. So within this objective, we can design this by changing the height and width of the slope. So this is here, this analysis is showing you that for different water conditions, what is the factor of safety? And you can find that as the amount of water will be more and more, your factor of safety is going to be decreasing. Starting with a very dry condition of 1.74 to a very wet condition of 1.20. So this factor of safety is decreasing drastically with the add of water. And for this condition, for the existing condition, the angle of inclination was going to be 31.64. And in this condition, it found that the slope is stable. And definitely, you can see that the slope is not like a model type of slope where everything is in a good state. And for that, we can redesign. Because they are working, when the water is being accumulated in the aquarium, they are just concentrating on the removal of the oil. So, yes, this is the working in design. So, we can also design for the fine boundary. They are going to achieve ultimate fit test. And beyond that, they are going for the under non mining operations. So, the ultimate fit test was designed at a depth of about 70 meters. So, they are looking for the design of the ultimate fit slope and slopes. So, for that, the angle was maintained something like that. Okay? With a factor of safety of about 1.5. This is going to be there for a very long period of time. So we are keeping this angle to the higher side. And you will see the angles or the slope angle of the visual plane, which is around 80 degrees. And the slope and height, that will be based on the machine which they are using. So they are keeping the height of the plane, which is 33 meters and width of the benches height. And as far as the dam design is concerned, lot of permutation and formulation has been carried out to find out this height, because as the water will be more and more, the chances of failure will be more and more. So you can increase the water head in this particular, in the right side of this dam, and you can find out what should be the angle. And here we are removing this black clay, all clay from this area, so that we can, this type of heating problem can be counter. So here you will find that this is going to give you a sufficient amount of stability, and here the caution is that you have to maintain the water stable in such a way that it should not go beyond a certain limit. So it was discussed cumulatively what is the amount of water is being coming out. So this variation of this water head has been done. It is found that for a particular 20 meter height of height of the water table behind the gate of this dam, it is good enough for creating a storage for this water. Then come to the this one, sliding of the infill dumps, that also has been done for a different, because this line is showing you the layer, the hard surface, and this is showing you the way they are deposited the dump layer. And for that, we have to go for a nice benching here again, so that the water, the material should not flow towards the bases. So such type of angles, they have to, they are now managing so that this type of failure will not get. So we can come to the conclusion, as material properties, if you look at that, water is increasing, the material property is reduced by the increase of water, and the safety factor is decreasing with the increase of water. So this is a general condition here. And out of that, the design water time is for 1.5 for factor of safety with 100% saturation. The working angle is coming to the 31.64 with 1.3 factor of safety. Generally, we are taking the factor of safety of the working benches. Around 1.5, and then overall slope angle, we are putting this ultimate slope for 27 degrees, and this regrading of the infill dumping is required, and so that we can check this sliding. And definitely, the next option is for the water management, which is very common as far as the slope stability is concerned. So, we can go for this type of pumping all around the periphery of your mine. As well as we can create the trenches so that we can control the washout of the basin, and we can align the flow of water in a particular area, and from there we can pump it out. So this type of collection of the dumps is required, some lining of the drains are required in grass areas also. So these are the water management which is there in the mine. Apart from the creation of the dam, this type of activity is also required for the greater stability of the greater stability and to control the water flow into the mine. So what is the recommendation for this? The recommendation was the genesis of all of what we are doing from mining activities. If you are doing the same work from the right direction, definitely we can, there will not be a problem. So how we can control this? We can first, for the deepest portion, we can go to the removal of the coal up to the deep. And from there, whatever the second and third blocks are there, we can remove this block from it to right direction. So this is one of the solutions which is there with this mining. And then after that, when we will come out from the deep to right direction, there is no need for the creation of this barrier. But till then, for the removal of the material from the deep side, we need to have this water right. So this is all about this presentation.
Lignite
having
not remember exactly.
I cannot say maybe about 1500 to 1300 water. It is a high capacity is 100% is about 4000. It is in the range of 4000. Because this is a very shallow deposit. And Gujarat is a very vibrant Gujarat. So they are looking for this type of removal of the silicon because they do not have other source of the time. They are removing it, there is no they can go ahead.
Whenever you are doing the due ordering, okay, you are telling that if you take the due ordering, the seat will be gone, it will be the problem. And so that you are making this one, seat will be deposited there, and what is going to be deposited there, after some monsoon, and next monsoon, you are changing to the water. But seat will be there. Seat you cannot change it.
One day, seat becomes dry, so you can establish it.
It will be more expensive than in that project will not have.
No, thing is that you are creating a barrier. Now, what was the earlier option? If this field is coming right at the whole thing, definitely you have to remove it and throw it off. But if you are putting a barrier and you can't get your all the things are taken off. So there is no issue. Now it is being confined within that default area, no coal is there now. So that is not an issue. So, main thing is that your motive is to remove the coal. If anyhow your coal is being overlaid or being what is called
But it should be documented.
Okay, thank you. Maximum 10 minutes. Within 10 minutes, you can take it to the end. 10 minutes.
We had a lot of technical issues, but we have been discussing so much on the technical issues. It's basically how to we integrate mine operation, mine planning, exploration, mine planning, deposit evaluation, and prosperity verification practices. And we're trying how we actually integrate everything with economics. So the discussion will move around that. The outline of the position. So this would be the outline of the position. So participants and engage in the upstream processes. The voltage that we are having at this verification, evaluation of the iron ore verification practices with time. So it's not that even the mine was opened and the plant that we are seeing over there, it was built at a single point of time, which basically in the operations that we see the test with time, with the maturity of our knowledges, with the of our deposits. Then, how to actually integrate deposit characteristics and its and with the growth plan of the company as well as the mines, and finally, the consumer plan. For the benefit of those who are not very familiar, we are having four iron ore mines, normally Katamati Yonai is one. Out of these four mines, Katamati Yonai and Thanwali is in Odisha and Wawamundi is in Arthur. And this story is basically on Wawamundi, but it's not much different from Jola and Thanwali. This is how we are linked with the upstream process of Katamati. We cater to the 100% captive requirement of iron ore to the sixth plant at coming up. The iron ore is produced in terms of lump sulf mines, lumps directly from blast furnaces, ions are basically rotated through sintering and pressurization, and finally we have a hot metal final product. These are the different geologies of ore. We have RO. Basically very hard, compact, massive sort of thing, and it's very precious, I mean, because it gives good lump yield and doesn't need any value addition before it is fed to the blast furnace. So it's a very precious thing, and unfortunately we are not blessed with much hard of now. And the other is lagnetics ore and fiber and blue dust. Basically, when you work in iron ore mine, if you see the statically the good ore, that is the hard ore that lies on the top of the deposit. followed by tribal and finally clueless. We know that the management peak as well. So normally when a mine opens up, we get good amount of hard ore and with little bit of other ore types. So basically the plant that normally was having in that, it was commissioned in 1967, it basically took care of the hard ore, a good amount of hard ore, almost 50% of the feed grade, feed material or hard ore and then hard ore. And the ROA needs to be crushed, it is a traditional washing circuit. After primary crushing, the minus 200 mm, here is minus 180 mm. If you go to the secondary crushing, after the scrubbing, the scrubbing classification, the overstage crushing, because it goes to circuit, and finally you used to have two products. Size stone, this is overstage plus stone, we call it LDO because it is used in every process for steel making. And the fines that after classification, it was used to be water, right? And the transfer was being produced. This was a very simple circuit, but with time what happened, with the expansion of the steel plant and the, as the mine progressed, according to the old one, the lumpy proportion in the mine reduced. So the plant lost because of the final particles in the feed ore type. But in normal registration circuit, what is basically, if you are in 0.2 mm, so whatever material is 0.2 mm in the feed, and some amount of fines that is generated between cracking and scrubbing actions that are reported as grinding. So basically, you don't have much lever to do anything with that. So it naturally goes as the used to go as the theory. And at the same time, the steel industry basically, the quality requirement of the raw material becomes stringent. So to do something on that, so basically we realize that we have, earlier we used to process only hard ore and all with different, whatever ore that was available in the wash plant. Now we realize that there are something, for example, if you, the customer wants 2% alumina in, I don't know, so the deposit is having some ore which is already having less alumina, that doesn't require any modification. So only we need to size it, I mean, crushing, steaming, and transfer to the steel plant. So we went for a 2 million, 2.5 million dry circuit plant. And also some capacity and hyperfixations of the existing works plant in phases to take inferior alumina. So when you take out less than 2.5% alumina from the heating, then the balance material was becoming inferior. So it requires some intervention in the plant also. And to do this, basically we classify the ore reserve into low, medium and high alumina. So the low alumina, if you see the, this is the gross properties, the mineralogy point of view is almost 80 to 90% hematite, and 9% goethite, 1% martite. This is the gang constant and some other not of much interest. So this material doesn't require actually any verification, but remember the hard work typically that the majority part of that falls under this category, and but because that gives a good lump yield and it contains sometimes alumina bearing minerals in as scales, arch scaling, something like that, so you can't crush the entire thing to the product. So with the exceptions of hard ore, the other material we use to process it by the feed plant, and the medium and high alumina material is processed in wash plant. Since 2006, we are pretty happy about this process, but at the same time, there was a dream was created because the deposit was, the balance material was becoming inferior and inferior, so there is a requirement to take inferior ore in the field. And also, it was required to enhance the lump ore products because it is the prime material for steelmaking. And of course, if you produce any material which is not produce bad quality, so we need to produce thinner lump. So, basically, if you see these two plants below, which basically shows that the at the production stage, the particle size is something like that, and that loading because of photogenic breakage, it was producing some understage, so we wanted to curve it. To do it, we classify the hard of the main prime material that generates the glass into different categories, and based on its lump width as well as its aluminum content, because we are more concerned about alumina, as we are blessed with good Fe in the entire iron ore in the world, here. So we have classified based on this, and we also wanted to have a batch processing philosophy in the plant. So we wanted to process the hard ore and other ores in other batches. So this is how actually the flow moves in. So by this is the same circuit. I mean, we have 2.5 million ton of dry circuit, dry processing plant, and around 5 million ton of wash circuit. We could improve the quality of product as well as the production of the prime material. That's the last. This is another case of upgradation of. So when we were trying to do that, then yes, because we have already taken our becoming in failure and it required another process intervention, so the jig plant was integrated, and to reduce the sign loss, fine was taken to hydrocentral circuit, and finally the product of dry circuit plant and our cell we bend and used to bend and bend to get cell. So this was happened till 2011. By the time we realized that there's a good amount of material still we can make use of, and for this was required because Jamshedpur plant was on for an expansion up to 10 million ton. So with this, basically we looked into the deposit angle. So if you see, this is what the dry circuit and wet circuit material distribution in the deposit of Normandy and Jodha. This was for Normandy, so almost 42% of material was less than 2.5% alumina. So we didn't require anything for this 42%. So if we match the plant capacities with this, so we could have done a very good job. But our plant capacity was something like this. So we had only production of 26% for the dry circuit plant and 74% for the wet plant. So simply what we did, and then Jodha, if you see, 47% was dry circuit material, 53% wet, and our plant capacity was 11%. Production was 11% from the dry circuit. We simply upgraded the dry circuit processing plant to close to the deposit ratio to optimize the mineral resources. So we have got production without any beneficiation intervention per se. We could improve the production without deteriorating the quality. So for doing this, what is actually needed? So that's my topic, is beneficiation or hardening. This thing needs to be integrated with everything. So it starts from geology, exploration, mine planning, mining, beneficiation. So this is how the story is built. So when you explore a deposit, you have a deposit and explore it, you prepare a geological model, say a rock model. Then, if you have a final the design in place and the schedule, I mean, how you are going to mine over time, year on year, and what would be the expected grade from different rocks, different areas of the mine, then you can plan your beneficiation strategy, production strategy much more clearly than normal circumstances. But story doesn't end here, because with the new regulations came in, I mean 45% cutoff for special value for iron ore by IBM. So we need to do a lot of many things, and this is what the future plan is. So we maybe by 2019 we are planning to have a application plan for low grade ore, so that is between 45 to 55%, and we could solve some problems. I mean from the cutoff of 55 through these interventions that we discussed it now. Thank you very much.
Why are you also deadly scared of the aluminum content? Is it a
Indian Idol. Not very India aware. Why is this technology not been taken up in India? Because this is an Indian over. Is anybody working on this? Because aluminum doesn't do any harm to the iron, but it does have to be blast furnace. It's harmful if it
affects.
Is there anybody working in India?
I am not very knowledgeable on that, but because anybody is working on that, but the problem lies with.
What is the question, sir? That how the aluminum will affect?
They are scared of the aluminum
content. I don't know.
And that, I don't know.
Let me tell you what happens. It's not aluminum, it is aluminum. So, what happens with the aluminum? When you try to. It basically increases the melting temperature, melting point of the slag. So when the melting point of the slag exceeds, so you need more coal to effect. So more coal consumption means you are less effective burning. So every 1% increase in aluminum content in your iron ore reduces the effective burning utilization by 3%. So that is basically an economical problem. It is not a technological problem, it is an economical problem. The blast furnaces, it is very difficult to replace. Fortunately, there are alternative processes up there, like coal exposures and other processes. But who are already having blast furnaces, what you are going to do? So you have to pay with the raw material. That is the challenge.
So
people are working. No, the Kores method is developed for that, but see, Tata Steel is already having blast furnace. SAIL is already having blast furnace. So you cannot replace it with the Kores. Whatever the new plants are having, they may think of.
Thank you so much. Basically, the solution lies in training. If you can have some
growth.
Thank you. As Dr. Prakash Singh has presented today, and Dr. Vishwas also presented, the mineralogy and the process mineralogy important in case of if you are going for a low grade ore to be very associated, because there are very complex issues. And basically, they dealt only with the iron ore, and we also have different type of ores. It is not only iron ore, there are also ores for magnet tantalum, there are also ores for rare earth, there are also ores for calcite. So the issues are different in different cases, and the mineralogical issues are also different in each case. So this is the title, where mineralogy and process mineralogy, the aspects engineers should look into, or environmental engineers should also look into, so that they can have benefit in case of beneficiation and environmental issues. Yes, sir. Okay, before starting that, I'd like to, as the Honorable Secretary of IIMD, I'd like to tell you that MPT 2016 will be held at Pune, and it is the internal seminar of IIMD, and there will be people from abroad who will come to that conference, the exhibitions, and it is one of the annual events of IIMD, it is held every year. So you are all welcome, and students, they can pay a fee of 1,000 rupees from all the students. They still will be there. ECS is organized this time, and in the headquarters, it is from 5th to 7th January 2015. So, as I thought that the second year students will be here, but I think they are not here. So, in this case, as a mineral, when you look, when you say mineral, the definition it is its composition and definite crystal structure, as you see here, and this would be discussed in that. Okay, in the as we call the rock, rock can be anything of in the natural aggregate of these minerals, one or more minerals, and that is the structure and texture also. And they can be from igneous source, like from megamelt, or from a sedimentary, or from metamorphic, or hydrothermal. There are four ways these rocks can form, and the deposits that you see as ore, they form by all these complex geological processes. And with that, what you define ore, from where you can extract metals, or even as minerals, and then recover your profit. You can recover the profit. So, in case of metallurgical ore, we used to have iron ore, chromite ore, nopal, copper ore. But the minerals, if you see, they are different. Ore minerals, iron ore. And in case of industrial minerals, when you say including minerals, this in the ore, when you define ore optical minerals, we mean the industrial minerals like limestone, dolomite, phosphorite, asbestos, ilmenite, rutile, and so many minerals, like even gave minerals like bentonite, plus or all this. That's right. So you can see, as I said, it has a definite crystal structure. If you see, the iron ore you die, it needs to have good crystals like this. And then it can be like this. These are like your museum specimens. But yeah, another case is like this. And then if you see it, it will be like pyrite and this. And then it is again magnetite in Hokkaido, but they are both as good system. And it is hematite, you can see like rosy metal, like plating minerals. It is composition Fe2O3. And in this, it is Fe2O4, but their attributes are slightly different. But they are all slightly and if you see chloride, looks like this. Okay, but its composition is calcium fluoride. Well, it is so it's also fluoride, but if it is there in the rock and it dwells, fluoride will go to the environment and it may cause fluorosis. If they have colored that way, so these are that causes natural health hazards. And if you see these deposits, you can classify them as igneous void, sedimentary void, metamorphic, hydrothermal. And the mode of occurrence is sometimes we call the stratiform, stratiform, and massive accumulated bore. Why I am saying this specifically is that in this data, right, thick data, that you have a different mining path, and if you have disseminated like hydrothermal layers, then you have tunnels and underground mining system. So, now, in this case, if you see this chromite and melanite, they are associated with ultramarine basaltic rocks and they are very measured in us, they are massive, high strength, and you need energy intensive milling. If you see a platinum group, nickel, cobalt, and titanium, they are associated with this gold, and there will be minor amount, low expected product, low volume, but they will be massive, high strength, and energy intensive milling. In case of granite and pegmatites, you can have spodumene, which contains lithium, which may contain ultramite, sphalerite, and this apatite. And these will be all with the old minor minerals, that means you have to dye about 1 ton of material to get some 0.1% or 0.3% of material from there. And in this case, you have a low yield and energy limit. And in the case of in the soil, this slide showing one for a variety rocks, that is nice rock where you can see some specs of this kind of mineral. And when it is associated with carbonatite, it used to call it columbite, tantalite, which is a resource for iron and and you can have rare elements like lanthanide, yttrium, rare mineral minerals. So, so, from engineering point of view, you should know what kind of minerals will be, what kind of rock type, and what kind of strategies you should adopt for the milling process. But in case of sedimentary deposits, like these are like sand, so it is already from the rocks, they are looking weathered, and these are the residual minerals which escape from weathering, so they are the seepage. And for this, simply you have to go by spiraling or magnetic separation, electrostatic separation, and you can recover. But wherever there is no stratiform deposits like limestone, phosphite, you may require some magnetization. And stratiform deposits, you may require sandstone, you may require conglomerates, they require dousing and separation. And sometimes it is not economic, so it's kind of they go for direct leaching because. So, when in Indian case, when you say uranium ore, it is 0.03% if you know it is ore, but in worldwide it is not. In worldwide, if it is, it is at least 0.2%. Then it comes to residual type deposits, which are oxide, kaolinite, like clay, bentonite. It is actually sodium monohydrate, but sorry, it is actually calcium monohydrate, but we should call it. Sodium monohydrate we use for iron ore, pellet. So you will see the major uranium type of deposits. There are ways it forms, multiple ways it can form. So these are some kind of examples given. So it goes into solution, uranium goes into solution and gets deposited back in. And then sometimes it will be in sandstone. In a reducing environment, it gets distributed as uranite within sandstone. So, sandstone is not a source, it is a secondary way of getting uranium getting deposited. So, as a mineral engineer, if you detect a uranium deposit in a sandstone, you have to crush it. It is a high strength method. And if it is not enough in concentration, you have to stay for release. This is the intelligent metallurgical processing that is following you. So uranium can also occur in some sort of veins. Yeah, we do not have that deposit in India, so we will not discuss much. And that can also occur in some conglomerates. The same process, it gets leached out and gets deposited within the conglomerates. Next, okay, in this case, what are the problems? The problems are that the granite deposits, you can get neither yttrium Today, in all you can have lithium, cesium, tantalum. This kind of association you can get. If you see the minerals, mineralogy, you can say that see the different type of minerals, cesium, titanium, niobium oxide, niobium, titanium, niobium oxide, niobium is a rare element, and cesium, niobium, tantalum, titanium, and you can see the uranium, titanium oxide, using the sodium, titanium, iron, so it's complex. Now, you have to know where niobium occurs, what type of minerals you have, and then you have to think your first mineral called granite, which is sorry. Now, it does this scale not given here, but if you see this scale here, it is 10 micron this mass, you can imagine this is the size of the grain. Any mineral process that goes 25 micron is fine, 25 micron okay, but 10 micron is difficult because the going towards colloidal size. So in this case, we have to see whether you can really recover this kind of material or else you have to go for process. And so in process mineralogy, what we like to see, whether we have a material which is processable, whether by grinding we have to reverse this grain. Or we have developed it by which you can do a grain pounding texture so that you can separate this kind of minerals by easy combination process. But it is yet to be developed. We are still on the process of doing that. So I will not speak about this because it's given something how old it was formed. But if you see the attributes again, in a pole, if you see the high grade pole, below the 1.4, you can see a lot of it is mostly minerals. But here you see silicate mineral association, and if you see this scale, it will be hardly something like 100 micron in thickness. So how will you separate it? It is related. Similarly, if you see the pyrite associated coal, you have to remove because you have to remove the sulfur. Similarly, here marker type, it is also quite iron sulfide. So how you have to separate? So if you see the dimensions, you will have to see. So you have to see the dimensions so that you know how much is grind so that they can be liberated. Next is the K mineral. If you see K is the interesting mineral. If you see bentonite is a type of clay which is used for magnetization of iron. And in this lattice, if you see there is a site here. Which is of water side, which is extensive cation, and this side is replaced by cations. So, very often this kind of minerals are used as catalyst, iron catalyst. So, this can be used for some kind of limitation of pollution. Okay, coming to iron ore, if you see. In Indian deposits, if you go to south of India, here you will get high-grade iron ore rocks. So, which is of granite. So, that's why this is the area from where whatever segment goes to the coast, that all is the granite. We have very rich granite and rare deposits around this. But if you see the iron ores here, and here are the iron ores, and you will see. Okay, I will not go much into this, but in the iron ore, you will see that we have magnetic ores here. So, if I go to the iron ore, yes, we should see accession of magnetic in the right. Similarly, we can see the and which can give a lot of fines because this magnetic amount is around 70 to 100 microns. So, 7 to 130 nanometers is magnetic hematite of 130 micron in dimension. And so, there are different types of reactions and these are massive cases. Our then discussion was leading to a reverse reversal study where you can do a reversal study. These are the interlocked cases, you can see like this. So, we should do a reversal study and we should see at which site we can time so that the teacher gets maximum liberation. So here you will see, he gets at a size of minus 70 plus micron. That means my goal is to guide it to that size. So you should guide us to clear the first size so that it will be 80% passing through of this size so that you can get a maximum benefit of liberation. So there are other issues like as Biswas said that you know, this galvanic gibbsite are the minerals that contribute to alumina. It is not always true, it is mostly true, but in some cases we have some high alumina goethite which can have alumina up to 15% and 14% silica. So this is as good as a can. So it is goethite, but it qualifies. This study you can do only by electron microanalyzer, it is not by microscope. So today the challenges are different. I will not go into the past detail, but the only thing I will say that in past India, our animal work on glufamide, where they are thinking for a grade which should be 60% glucose. But today, even 10% glucose, we can extract well with the economic level. So, over the period of time, the challenge changes. And if you see about the commodity pricing, nylon, tantalum, PPTs, nylon oxide, it is minimum 50% should be there so that it is in market. Tantalum oxide, if it is natural, then it is in the market, it is in market. But Indian challenge is different. And if you see, these ores used to have high sodium and uranium also. They used to have some radioactive effects. So there are some health other issues. So for transport and for mining, it is one material for mining and handling, and 10 material for transport is the interest of all. So we will have to have that kind of database also. So in case of mining, you will have to see that over a period of time, here it is a magnetic ore with phosphate, and here it is non-magnetic, it is magnetic ore without phosphate. So over a period of time, you go mining deeper and deeper. So there are issues for mining areas as well, where they have to go for handling the ores and different issues, environmental issues as well as grade issues. And industrial synchronization, different from mining area, mineral area, and process area. Thank you. So, is there any question you can always communicate to us through this email ID? So, students, specifically, if they have any questions, they are also communicate to us.
If any questions, please hold on.
I think there's not much question because I don't know the time is up. I can't do that much time.
Okay, thank you. Thank you,
sir. I request Principal sir to please present the moment.
Oh, that's already gone. What was that? I got old. I said just. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
So now we move to the next area.
That is Dr. Sohan Gill from Pollution Control Board, Odisha. Very interesting to get the environmental point of view.
Good
afternoon, everybody. So, because all the sessions are very highly technical, but I have all the slides for the student session so that it is mostly tutorial and what are the pollution control measures taken by the different mines in terms of radio office that I will describe. The topic is pollution control measures adopted in the iron and manganese ore mines in terms of the state. responsibility to plan a comprehensive program for prevention, control and avoidance of pollution and enforce the environmental laws. To advise the state government on any matter concerning prevention and control of water and air pollution. To enforce statutory available conditions like Water Act, Air Quality Act, and Environmental Protection Act and other rules and organization plan. And to conduct environmental monitoring and research and finally to create public awareness. So this is a scenario about the industries. So in particular in Delaware district, there are two industries, three different industries, having an annual production capacity of 193 and 6 megawatt industries, having 80,600 tons per annum, spot iron, having capacity of 2.42 million tons per annum, 5 iron ore pellet plants, and capacity of 40 million iron ore beneficiation plants, having production capacity of 16.32 million tons per annum. And this is some industries have their own captive power generation, and the total captive power generation is 175 megawatts. So then coming to the mine scenario, the total number of mines in Delaware district is 102, from which 55 are only iron ore mines, 19 mines produce gold, iron and manganese ore mines, and 18 mines produce manganese ore. Apart from this, there are 4 copper ore mines and 6 valuable mines. So in Delaware district, the total production of iron and manganese of the 92 mines, is iron ore is 153.859 million tons per annum, and manganese ore is only 1.685 million tons. But at present, only 24 iron ore mines are in operation, which is for producing around 40-50 million tons. Yes. So these are the larger capacity producing iron ore mines like Rupa mines, Sivanjodhan mines, then Tata Steel, Shell, Oak, I have lot of slides, so I will do it faster. So this is a view of iron ore mines where it is situated in the mountains. So Japan mining is done from the top to the bottom. And there are some mines where mining is done on the slope of the mountain itself. And these are most prone to air and water pollution. This is a general process of mine. So what are the sources of pollution in mines? One is, first is drilling, blasting, mineral ore transportation inside mine is areas, then mineral ore processing, like crusher plant, spinning plant, beneficiation plant, then solid waste generation from mines and power mill, like solid waste from mines, overburden, sulfate ores and tailings, then hazardous waste, and all these mines have their own problem, so outdoor waste is also generated, biological waste and evaporative waste. But this is So this is the area where more research has to be done. Then another the physical cause and lesson area is the transportation during mineral transportation within the this area. So the alcohol as well as the mineral after excavation is transported to the designated area for processing and starting from the mine or the lower. Since the heavy vehicles are used for transportation of materials from one place to another, generation of sugar physical gas is quite expected. For this, the mines are provided with the fixed type water spraying system which are automated and the timer is set. So depending on the time and the season, so water can be spread on this transportation road. Next, there is an area where this fixed type of water spreader cannot be provided. Then this tankers are provided with jet spray system which can cover the larger roads and they can be transported to a working area like muscle plants, mine banks, etc. Then another thing is that getting off road of transportation road. This particular road, actually this transportation road controls more than 20 gas. So if the road is graded and water is sprinkled, so there is less transportation. So now another new system has been developed, that is quick dispatch system. Then on the wheel itself, the work can be added. So the truck has not had to go to the internals and get twice. Then back of your transportation road, that is then the mineral processing area, just pressure plant, iron ore pressure plant, which may be either stationary or mobile type, or iron ore spinning plant, which may also be stationary or mobile type. So in all stationary and mobile type pressure, high pressure water spinning and dry box has been provided, which suffers the dust itself or the source. And another now new technologies come for a bigger size pressure, that is called the air filter. Water and air is being sucked and the plane may drop the filter bags, then plane has been sucked to the atmosphere. Then all other areas like pump bags are being covered with the ACs. So these are the type of covered and you can mobile pressure itself. So the physical dust generated at the point itself is being generated. This is a nice dish. So now another new system that is mist gun spray. This Tata and two or three new matches got this. The advantage is that it can throw the mist up to a distance of 50 meters and it can move 360 degrees. So that larger coverage area, the physical dust can be converted. This is the picture of the gun filters. Then covering up this processing plant. Then already in the other season, a lot of discussion has been made on the beneficiation plants. So here in the beneficiation plant, the only problem is the handling of the tailings. Tailings is nothing but soil mixed with water. And what is now, it is unwanted material for the miners. So they are handling that. They are either disposed in the group form. Now new technology, previously these are all slime dams where all the tailings are being collected and the water is recirculated to the process and the tailing has stopped. So when this is filled up, then they go for another tailing dam. But now new technology has come. These tailings have been subjected to filter press. By this process, these tailings have been found, filtered and being collected. And the water is clear water is being added even like this. Then handling of the solid waste in mines. The solid waste generator are found in overburden regions, sub-urban mantles and tailings. The generation of solid waste in iron ore mines is very less, that is ratio is 1 to 0.1 to 0.5. Whereas the ratio of generation of water in manganese mine is 1:5:10. So a lot of the solid waste are generated in manganese ore mines. So what are the management options? Management options are just dumping of OPM sulfur materials in the active site system and maintenance with proper vacuum testing, fire fighting and application of waste gas sheets, vertical gas plantation, after stabilization plantation with the provision of agriculture work, talent, bread and settling bonds. So these are all the subject terms, then science terms being covered in wireframes. So then other options are this from providing towards around the terms area. So that there is no WhatsApp is there, and whatever WhatsApp is there, then they will connect it in this dynamic setting forms will be provided. So this is the last setting has been some challenges I want to be so. Sir, some of these options for controlling the surface around us. Actually, the prepared comes happened to us. These are the more the problem, the challenge in mining area. What we see that we are limited to the mine premises itself. So what our boss says, the person control can go up to the mine area or industrial premises, and we can address the pollution there. But the main pollution what is being observed by SAR Commission and this time Mr. Sahu is sitting here. But we observe that in the transportation road, the main pollution occurs. So these are the figures if you are planning website of the truck, then you can see the road. All the vegetation on both sides of the road has been done. Next, please. So these are some suggestions. That is, I will place the report to the environmental. This will take off and place it before the district association so that these things can change. That is why the reduction, conversion of compass of rural carrying capacity to higher capacity, that is 10 to 20 tons, resulting in reduction of vehicles and increase of pollution load in form of dust and gas, raising up the overcrust and dampers of 10 ton capacity, laptoping, completing of transportation load and continuously maintained, carrying concrete on both sides of transportation road to reduce physical dust, laptoping, completing the connecting roads. Dedicated urban vacuum cleaners for giving the transportation level, then dedicated high-level transport for it. So these are the instruments. Then installation of speed drivers to limit the speed of truck. Then no overheating of vehicles by car numbers. No customer buses or loading of alcohol from the mines. Water screen for carrying the dust and clothing on the vegetation. Dedicated mobile water tanker for water drinking on the transportation road, massive plantation, compulsory tarpaulin covers on the iron ore and fans, then regular removing of spill-on overs and fans accumulated in the street breakers on the transportation road, and provision of regular siding inside mines, and enhancement of regular net loading facility for rapid loading system, and provision of high coverage system of iron ore from mines to the nearest railway siding. This is the last slide. Then this is suggestion for control of mine runoff water and river water pollution. All mine owners should get your scientific surface runoff study for their mines, taking maximum rainfall of their area into account. Then effective management of surface runoff water will constructing diamond dams, number of check dams, filtration pond, water harvesting pond. The capacity of this filtration pond should have a water intensive time of more than 5 to 10 hours. Then development of power vehicle washing terminals, having different water treatment plants and complete recycling of treated water. Then finally, no washing of vehicles in the perennial water streams or rivers because they pollute more into the river system. Okay, thank you. Hello, hello, sir, question. One question, please. Sir, is it becoming viable that if you add up all these provisions in mining industry, get different prevailing conditions?
Pardon?
Sir,
Sir, is it economic viable that particular state all this provisions?
Now, practically, it is not possible because district administration does not have the plan, nor is the infrastructure to grow this state. But now, by the new act, mineral act, one mineral fund has been created, and that fund is a huge amount, and this is possible.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. That was a really nice and excellent presentation. I would like to sir to give the memento to Dr. Swami, sir. Sir, this one.
Thank you, sir. We'll proceed to next item, which is the talk by ASC Khatur. We are very happy to listen from KSR President, Citizen Forum of Kerala. He is economy and listening all with us from morning till now, and please come to the
My name is Mr. Linders. Next. Mr. Tendulkar is not so restored. He is the mighty investor of the best and the largest deposit for the Arab or Saudi region of the Terry, Hong Kong, Arthur, and Budapur. Next is only deposit of strategic mental promise in Bola, in the bed. Quality deposit of handling gold in the famous Yoda Kolda Magazine of Bangalore. Nickel ore in the promised ore body and vanadium in adjoining mineral wells. Thus, this district is uniquely positioned for the best quality steel making, supported by ore and other materials from the neighboring districts. Next. In addition to nearness to these vital raw materials, Kendusa provides cheap land, salubrious climate, abundant soft water, surplus electricity, peaceful labor, reasonably good roads and rails, both existing and other construction, airports, and finally nearness to markets and stores. And yet we have not been able to attract quality investment. Some have come here to meet these challenges with big promises only to withdraw or delaying decisions possibly because capital finds and generous export continue to remain to the ultimate aim. In 2017, the citizens had resorted to public education in the location of the public sector steel unit was unprofessionally rejected by steel ministry. In spite of the fact that government tells Mayagar and our district has the best location in India among the 20 sites examined by MS Consultant Personal Center. Now, after years of waiting, it is heartening to know that India's two Navaratna public sectors, namely NMDC and state, are now expected to choose Kendusa for a more major Ultra mega steel plant providers. Lately, we hope for citizens and residents that three major steel plants, three majors, left Kendusa ostensibly in the absence of help support from the government, the departure of Ashkala Kintan, Stellite Industries, and Uttam Galwa, then citizens here to come out. Possibilities elaborated. Next. Our district has already shortlisted two most suitable locations among many others. A, adequate land available now, scaled down to only 3,600 to 4,000 acres at both Patna and Bhopal. The possibility possible participation of OMC with raw material leakage of quality iron ore from nearby Bandhumarjan, possibly even by conveyor belt, was completed in May. Dispersed mineral processing to enrich ore quality while discovering this solid waste back to enrich the depleted forest while returning the used water to enrich dark water and mountain streams. Adequacy of water from proposed virtual barrels at Rajnagar. Sufficient power now available from 450 stations of power grid at nearby Maranpur, avoiding captive generation and consequent reduced pollution. An electrified double line rail linkage to port to East Coast to be ready by March 2016. A proposed rail link from Chandigarh to Badampara, already surveyed and estimated by Southeast Railway, connects us to Sri City of Jamshedpur and Gold Belt of Jamshedpur through this proposed new rail line. The 4-6 laning of National Highway with good retail ports and markets in fast progress in India in about a year or so. The highly motivated, technically qualified and skilled youth from our own technical institutions are available. A peaceful labor force is ready to skill development program launched by Government of Odisha. Nearest existing secondary and tertiary industrial hubs of Rabindranagar, Angul, Rourkela, Jamshedpur, Ranchi, and finally Kolkata, Kharagpur for much needed mutual support. Next. What exactly we want? Opportunity is gain. While seeking support for such major investments in mines, minerals, processing, and steel making, let us air some of our expectations and apprehensions in the line of CSR for inclusive growth, as against CSR currently practiced with nothing more than CRI. Firstly, the investors should more than meet the environmental role of the nation by bringing more modern technology and best engineering practices. Minimum waste from effluents mainly reduce damage to our forest, air, water, and soil. Secondly, settlement and rehabilitation, an adequate package as per the current policy and transparent discussion, are needed for such a distracting and complicated task. Thirdly, it would show appropriate bias towards the people of our neighbors. Neighboring paper districts of our district as well as our neighboring paper districts of Boyabon, Sundagar, Devgar, and in Sinbhum for employment and business relations. Fourthly, the question adequate support for meetings and investments in the area of science, technology, education, and medicine in our area. And finally, to develop and encourage and create all over these districts to give some quality employment and self-employment for our youth and entrepreneurs in the neighborhood of the Rajasthan. Next slide. Looking back at the resource base, unlike many other mineral bearing areas of the world, in India, the iron ore appears under the heels of thick rainforests inhabited by dispersed tribal populations, where most of the rivers originate. Therefore, taking out minerals from underneath such areas on Mother Earth also indicates special challenges for both mining and mineral processing areas. Within the bounds of law, legislated to meet our own needs as well as not necessary. Let us take a look at our mining industry in the forest of Kerala. Recent records show the mining lease area granted to 109 mines. So I'm talking about 92 mines, I don't know, 109 mines. Iron ore, manganese and chromite. Over a total area of 33,560 hectares, within the same ML area, there are 24,112 hectares of forest land. The rest, 9,248 hectares are revenue and private land together. At the same time, the area of forest land diverted for non-forest use, technically called conservation area, adds up to 6,102 hectares. For 24,112 hectares of forest land occupied by the leaseholders. This works out only about 55.3% of the forest land under their own. Thus, the area of forest land of over 18,000 hectares remains within the mining lease area, but outside the care of both the forest department and the leasehold. The known case of illegal embryonic mining is secondary and tertiary source of minerals for many operators. As the data above indicates, the mining industry has not even compensated for the loss of the forest cover caused by it. They appear to take shelter under a lot of confusing guidelines like broken land, fragile land, removal of trees, non-compliance of EMP prior to the end of lease period, in the instance of continued operations, etc. They lobby hard with many committees to their strongly organized association. And legal luminaries, they all make their commercial interests. There are, however, a few exceptions. Thanks to most unscrupulous funds among them, just one donation we have handed down that may have been forest in the name of growth elsewhere, in complete contrast to the objective of the law that we claim for ourselves. Some of the satellite pictures of NRSA show civilians at home. Forest cover in Kendur are revealing. To an ordinary observer, the fields of Kendur appear to be far worse than the coastal districts where there are little or no natural forests. Here lies the challenges for the mining sector in being media system. During mining operations, the status of the land or system remains unchanged as first. It is because it's closer to the mines, the land is to restore back to the environment management plan, and for the environment management plan, the most important part of any mining plan. EMP, or the environmental plan, is a continuous process which the mining engineers have deliberately neglected in recent days to meet the exponential growth targets. Abandoned mine areas are left to the murder of forest cover. Indian Group of Mines are to enforce the provisions of NCBRITA on measures of protection of environment. These measures cost money. unlike embedded consultants meeting GIA reports of the management press. Instead, if you found the daily has carried out as study, some of us who attended the seminar on that day, hotel ground, to lay down what is environmental carrying capacity of temperature for mining. They have laid a figure of 143 million tons per day, whereas the highest that we have reached here in 2010 is 57.71 million tons. So this is what, even as public sector environment we in Kendal are disillusioned. This is one. We in Kendal are disillusioned by the present state of governance, by a weak in delivery, never a bottom-down approach, always imposed from the government. Now on, we will increasingly depend on the new age professionals like you to address the significant needs of sustainability, environment, and wellness of the pursuit of their career and our future. Thank you.
He knows all the answers. He can even see the answers. You know every answer, so any questions they can ask.
Any questions on me? No.
Okay, we'll move to
that. You can take it from me.
Afterwards, we can talk a little bit.
A little bit, I want to tell you. The World Business Council, WBC, very quiet about the way the business was being looked at by the population of the world, common people. They call this ICMM, International Council of Magicians, told them that you all are one of the reasons why people are against us. Because we know that mine, mineral processing, and metal extraction produces the maximum solid waste, liquid waste, and gaseous waste among all the industries. People are not looking up. Therefore, they framed those SDA, Sustainable Development Framework, a lot of things have been done. But it is looking at new engineers go through those provisions and make mining the most important risk activity on the most creation depends on the environment, people friendly, and industry. This is my
specialization in mineral processing and I am a faculty of mining engineering.
And my PhD students are either from mechanical engineering background or from mechanical engineering background. Now, I look at it, now what is the major processing this is basically? You talk about this side, that side, I don't look at it like this. Who are the major professionals in this field? You know, the, let's say the mechanical engineering graduates, then the geology and mining side by side. You have got applied geology, you have got metallurgies, you have got chemistry people, chemical engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, DCS, computer science, electronics, all are contributing into developing technology of mineral engineering. Now, what is that? So basically it's a team work, but if you work in isolation, you cannot develop technology. What is the role of the various players? The field geologist must find and recognize the role. Then the mineralogist must examine in detail for mineral content and rocking characteristics. Analytical chemist must detail with the elements first, mining engineers should mine, then it is coming to the processing unit. Now, to look at the challenges, see clearly is what are there for mineral processing unit. Mining engineers, they are after only production. They don't care what they are mining. It is like your own sort of Dadagiri, you know that I have got this, I'll produce this. You have to accept mineral processing engineers. And metallurgists are there, no, I cannot accept this. I need this, I don't go to need that. Alumina, my idea ho jayega, wo ho jayega. Both my idea has been for a change. But the mineral processing engineers will go. Basically, if you look at the tree, the mineral processing engineers should actually dictate. They should tell mining engineers that you are not allowed to mine if the ore is like this. They should tell that metallurgist that this is the best I can give you. You develop your technology. You should that. Anyway, that is my view. So what are the challenges? The global challenges for mineral processing, you look at the depleting rate of ore, falling prices, that is specifically fluctuating prices, not only always falling. So how to think with technology to that? Stringent specification and demands. Specification by environmental people, specification by the user industry. We should do energy savings. There are many, say, energy say intensive processes are there. How do I say energy that? Then you are hard work the whole day that we are having the problems with the processing of mines and other mines. Recycling of water and chemicals. How do I recycle? Otherwise, the environmental people will get. Then your surface water quality, ground water quality, self disposal of carbon storage, you can keep on progressing. What are the mineral processing needs? Please don't misunderstand me, I am trying to energize. Many people who are in the mineral processing industry, we have tried everything, nothing can be done. Then we tried it before, I have to follow sir, I can tell you, then to us. Our ore is very difficult, you cannot do it. Then our ore changes frequently. Only miracle reagents can do it, sir. Then it is difficult to get great recovery power or recovery optimized ore. Sorry, I cannot do it. These are the needs. We know a little about basics, but we want the miracle reagent. Is it really possible? So what we have to know, that please realize that you need to know the basics first. To make a miracle. It may be a machine, it may be a reagent, it may be a new process. So you have to understand the basics. Then you look at the key areas in mineral processing. Sampling and analysis, probably least taken care of. Because we don't teach you the sampling, the analysis methods in our mineral processing process. But this is the most important thing because your entire value from your mining to extraction lies on how good was the sampling. Because otherwise, you start claiming that my ore is different, my ore is getting depleted and all this. Because we have not assessed that. Material handling, it is not deep talk. Mineral processing is nothing but you just take out the unit operations, what you are left to it. How do you connect the different unit operations? These are basically pipelines. These are basically conveyor belts. So it's a material handling. How much of you are being taught. I'm saying not only here, in India, say, at the media general degree courses,
These are not being taught. What we have taught? Class is riding a cycle is possible. But I have to know this. That is what I do. Now, let us see the challenges, more technical challenges for the so-called user processing people. What are the key components in concentration processing? First, we have to break. We call it deliberation, that is the communication. Then there are gravity concentration, your classification, other processes are there, magnetic acceleration, electrostatic, all these are there. But key operations are this, regular flotation. These are the main key operations. Then look at communication. It's a very, very energy intensive area. 99% the energy consumed in communication goes for the operating the equipment, producing noise and heat. Only 1% of this energy is being effectively utilized for creating subculture. That is what the job. Now, look at it in combination, do a little bit of site operation, a bit of upgradation also, by putting a classifier or various screens or something like that. You know, the possibility of time I cannot explain immediately. Here I want to stress upon that you look at that different names what you do. I say that combination starts from your plastic. That is your explosive saturday, that these are the size changes and we keep the different names. And the professor Barman was asking someone that what are the problems with grinding and all this. You see that energy consumption, when the particle size becomes higher than higher, the energy consumption goes up. Suits up. Now, what we can do? Here also you have been taught mining. You have got mining, say mining engineering department, you have got metallurgy, you have got metal processing. I think this is the ideal place to start working on these areas. Like blasting practices, if you look at here, blasting energy efficiency ranges from 10 to 20%. And as I said, even with the modernization of my combination equipment, here the energy utilization is only 1-2%. Why don't we talk to each other? Why don't we use more of the fundamental principles of getting the equipment or whatever the methodology we use in blasting to reduce some of the combination states? Why can't we handle that? Because the effective energy utilization is more there. So automatically my pollution and everything will be reduced, you know, to take care of this. Now, this is not the first time I'm talking. So basically, from the place where I did my PhD from JKYC University of Queensland, they started it 15 years back. And now this technology has been transferred to Metro and they are implementing it many places. Here actually what is the role, you know, the geologists, mining engineers, metal processing engineers, software engineers, computer science people, all are working together for this. And that is how they have developed this and they have demonstrated in many plants that total energy saving was more than 15%. Think of it. That is what my emphasis is, that work together. Don't confine your domain. My mining engineer would recommend to mineral processing, that is not me. I am a mineral processing engineer, I don't need to understand what mining engineer does or what a metallurgist. Otherwise, you cannot solve this type of problem. Now, to look at what are the basically the innovations or the research that are going on in competition for saving of energy, you know, other processes. These are basically the people that try for thermal soft, that is how to induce thermal soft. Even I also, initiated one idea in IIT Kharagpur, but that is now in temporary state. That is, why can't we, what will happen if I put that off into a climate condition that is like, such as below minus 196 degrees centigrade temperature. So there you will be having a thermal soft because the, your rocks are basically heterogeneous material. And you have got different minerals, and the different minerals will be having different types of thermal conductivity. So what will happen if I put it into a thermal soft? Then what I'm doing. But people have tried microwaves and other heating materials. Pressure changes, water compartment, other areas like chemical forces, digestion, dissolution, compulsion, biology. All aim is that how do I minimize the energy consumption. Look at flotation. Flotation earlier it was doing your different stages, that is the conversion with flotation cells. Now, the bottom flotation cell has come up. There are many talks here about bottom flotation. And based on this idea, there are some other cells, Jameson cells, micro cells, all these are developed. But you know, the very few units are industrial scale assets. because the problem is the capacity. So what do you have to do? The research problem is that how do I scale it up? In the laboratory I may have developed a process, but to transfer it to the industry, you need to do solve engineering problems. That is, how do I scale it up? You have to understand the total engineering, otherwise you cannot make. And you have to work in a team. That is not a single man's job. It has to be a teamwork. So if you look at a flotation, what are the main objectives? Improve recovery of excellent flotation plant. What are the sub objectives? That improve combination and classification, plant operating control procedures, plant instrumentation, circuit design, and all that. And you see that globally, what are the people they are working? But we are not doing in India. Metallurgy and mining people, they are working. Instrumentation and electronics people, geology, chemistry, chemical engineering, mathematics, software engineering, mechanical, civil engineering, all are working together for developing of a technology for flotation. That is what is required. And I think this time is place to start that. So I'm reiterating. You look at gravity concentration, people say it is awful. In my next slide. Look at more than 60% or 70% of coal, they are still being washed or upgraded by gravity concentration. Diamond still be processed by gravity concentration. There are many minerals where the gravity concentration is the main unit operation that is causing the displacement minerals. Then your basically people used to think that when my particles are refined, the flotation is the only solution. But now there are developments even in gravity concentration technology. Well, you can deal with the very fine particles also. Now, major unit operation and the ability to process aggregates due to recent innovation full potential not explored basically. You look at journal articles published in mineral processing, you will find that either they are on combination or they are on flotation. Only two papers they are published on gravity concentration. It is a huge area for research, but the essential key element there is that you have to have good knowledge in fluid mechanics, because otherwise you cannot deal with this. So again, you have to study fluid mechanics also to contribute in gravity concentration. If you look at the broad classification of gravity concentrators, they can be put into three, flowing fluid, centrifugal, separators based on flotation, or rust to the slides, because we all know all this. So what are the limitations, you know, for the basically this gravity concentrator? That is, in addition to the very fine particles, you say low throughput and equipment selection. Which equipment are you to select for one purpose, for one application? Non-availability of tailor-made designs. Manufacturers, equipment manufacturers, they will make one equipment and they will say that it will work for, I don't know, to gold and the diamond and platinum, whatever it will say that this will work. No, sir, it cannot work. You have to find people. But to do that, what do you do? We have to understand how it works. So that is a lack of fundamental understanding. There is no fundamental model available there. How do they work? We just say that you put it here, the fit goes like this, some comes down, some goes up. That is not the interpretation. That is not how you should look at it. Otherwise, you cannot modify the design. Okay? You look at the centrifugal separators, they are enhanced gravity concentrators, probably you have heard. So I'll talk a bit of this, and this hydrocyclone, you know. You look at the challenges. Normally, even in textbook, it says that there is a solid flow, it goes there, mg square by r, particle gets separated. No. You have to go beyond that. That is, you look at the solid flow, basically the high turbulence. How do I handle with the turbulence? How the particles get mixed with the turbulence? The presence of solids, how do they affect? The airport is a three-phase, multi-phase problem. It's a huge, huge fluid mechanics related problem. If you want to design one, if you modify the design, you have to go to that level. Otherwise, that is the fundamental level. Otherwise, you cannot modify the design at all. Then, my question is that, why the cyclone should be always cylindrical? Or say, cylindrical conical? Why that shape? Why not this shape? That is your cylindrical vessel. Because, now, here I did a lot of work for cold washing, and I have shown the cylindrical vessels are much greater than cylindrical conical vessels for cold washing. But again, I am saying that it is very difficult to ask for the knowledge what you develop in academic institute or in research laboratories in the industry. It will take time. It takes time normally in mining industry, the technology transformation, you know, it changes around 30 to 40 years. You look at the history of anything. It is very slow process. Enhanced gravity concentration. Okay, I'll skip through this slide so that you don't have the time. And then we come to that. So basically, these enhanced gravity concentrations, why they are different? People like that. People have presented that most of them are the gravity concentrators. Because the ability is that it has the potential to replace the potential. But challenge is again engineering challenge. That is, the capacity is the main problem. It is a basically you are rotating your vessel. So what is the problem? The dynamic stability is the problem. So it's a typical mechanical engineering problem. It is not only the process problem, it is the engineering problem. Then industry demands also drive efficiency. Demanding. So there will be demand. There will be demand more with the time because we are having scarcity of water. People may say that. No, you cannot use the water. So we have to look for drive efficiency. So but the problem is that drive initiation, the techniques are being developed, but still not many drive initiation techniques which can handle the huge quantity of material. Again, this is a research area, you can go for that. But I am saying that not only the process part, you have to look at the total engineering part. Otherwise, you cannot develop the technology. So general perception, that is, I have been operating the plant, but we can accommodate. That is normally the mindset problem in the industry. So you go there, sir, I want a research project to do this. They say, what are you talking? You don't have any problem. I am operating this plant for such a long time. I don't see any problem. It is not a disrespect to anyone. It is just a trying to tell you. Some will say, what is there by winter processing plant? It's a very simple subject. Pani mein dal do, ghuma do, nikal jaye. And generally, this is the perception for the mining people. So, with these apologies, gentlemen, may I request answers to the comment? I can give question hundreds of questions, but three questions I'll say. Do we have instruments which can sense the degree of liberation say I'm doing it? Because when the mill is running, if I can sense that what is the degree of liberation, and if I have achieved that, we'll just move it. But with the sensor, what it will sense, how it will sense. Do we have online sensors? We have online sensors to measure the pulp chemistry and rotation hydrodynamics. We are saying that this is the chemistry of, but when it is in large quantities, how do they react? How the chemical is working? Can we not have a sensor to sense that? Then I know what is the hydrodynamic going on. Do we know the roles of centrifugal forces, volumetric, etc., or particle separation? Sometimes I am saying, sometimes I am going to SMR, twice. So we have to have engineering solutions. That I want to do a given this physics, so this will be the geometry of that. Now, the fact is that, now I'm coming to that, what are the real challenges, you know, the real problems. The research emphasis should be on fundamentals, very easy to say. But the difficulty in the scientific approach, not only to the processing in these art sciences, including mining, geology, and everything, is that solid particles are difficult to define, quantitative, and handle theoretically. But fluid, I can easily say that this is the property of this fluid, at this temperature, that this is the viscosity, this is the density. For a particle, it is very difficult, you have to measure. So, I cannot have a model which can predict that this will be the density of my mineral, this will be the density of this, the permeability of this, like that, the physical property. Mineral engineering discipline requires only a small number of engineers, that's true. But this must have advanced engineering skills. Because you have to deal with both mining and metallurgy. So you have to satisfy both. So you have to have more technical competence, okay? A thorough understanding of minerals and their unique processing characteristics. You know, I will give you one statistic. In USA, the number of graduate students in mineral engineering dropped from 700 in 1980 to less than 100 per year now. Whereas in China, this number has gone up 10 times. A day will come when the entire world will depend on China. Now it has already started. Everybody is going for China. Now it is a high time for us that we develop our skills, mainly in mining, processing, and metallurgy, so that we don't have to look for technology from China. Now, no expertise in advanced areas in our mineral processing in this area, like not develop skills in instrumentation, process control, software development, bulk material handling, fluid mechanics,
material science. How do I know what is the layer of my material if I don't know the material science? So these knowledge we should have. They are not integrated with bio and hydro mineralization. We should have knowledge in that. Not exploring enough the potential of bio mineral processes. Why I have to mine my batteries if they are capable of taking out my mineral? Is it not? Sometimes I tell you, yesterday I was telling that what is that technology we are doing? We are having some ppm level of gold, 2 ppm. That is considered to be a high grade gold. 2 ppm means 1 ton of rock I am mining, I am expecting 2 grams of gold. And for that, if I was to mine here, also break here, and then we could do that. And still, in that process, I am losing 2 grams. So, is this the technology? Can we not have some in situ mining? Then SAR will not have any problem. Then SAR will not have any problem related to environment. Can you not think of it? I'm requesting that we have a problem. Don't ask me that, do you have any solution? If I have a solution, I would not have given it. I would have developed the technology. Then strategies. So, what strategy we should adopt? That is innovative starting configuration. Model and desires. Linking of existing units with improvised unit operations. Why don't you look at interdisciplinary subjects, what they are doing? Bring those concepts, make it tailor-made to suit our needs. Maybe a database to elicit various, like your, say, your column information or this fluidization one. Fluidization is a new subject in clinical engineering. There are books, there are courses being done. Now, mineral processing people are trying to borrow those knowledge. So, for our mineral course, that is exactly what we should do. Now, for the survival and growth for mineral engineers, we must do that. Implementation of selective mining methods wherever possible, these mining engineers also should cooperate. Control from exploration to metallurgical plant. It is not that I will try to look at mining is separate, mineral processing is separate, metallurgy is separate, product development is separate. Overall integrated metallurgical performance, I must do that. Transfer of proven technologies in similar industries. Highly skilled staff for planning, control, and maintenance. Try new technologies for getting immediate benefits. Okay? Don't be afraid of trying new technologies. Develop robust techno-economic models incorporating 4 to 3 scores. Don't look at isolation. Don't do financial analysis in isolation. Environment friendly technologies should be high value materials for mineral work. Let us try to use your mineral work for cement and other utilization like tiles or whatever. Biotechnology for mineral extraction can be thought of. Energy saving technologies will try to get out. Now, for this, what are the responsibilities for mineral engineers? Consider the pre and post processing aspects while designing your process. Don't look at only the post processing that I have to. Upgrade from this field. You have to look at the consequences. What will be the water consumption? How much of effluent will be going with my water? And can I not reduce the water consumption? Can I not go for some other mitigation techniques? Okay. Explore the potential for value addition. What am I going to do with the tails? Dumping is not the solution. It will again come back to you. Whatever you are dumping, it will come back in some form to you. So can I not utilize it? So that is for geo-waste technology. Go for interdisciplinary team effort in structuring and planning in cities, all the people. Industry, R&D institutions and universities should play responsible roles for better tomorrow. And as because it is an university, I'll share my last few slides. That is in education, is there any change required? In education, basically there is no group on case studies in the process. Why don't you try to write some books on case studies, the industry people can help us. Also, links between mineral industry and education system is strengthened for the greater benefit of both. Industry people always say, oh, academic research output should have, latter look, kuch nahi janta hai, yahan se aata hai, kya padhata hai, pata nahi. Why don't we have some forums? Why don't we have this education system where the continuous interaction between the industry and students and faculty should be there so that my courses will be more practical oriented. The aim, it will boil down to the quality of people recruited, how they are trained and used. Above all, how we can inspire them, how we can motivate them people who are joining mining and your metal engineering disciplines, extractive metal engineering, they are not coming to this discipline because of jobs. They are coming, they are joining this discipline like compulsors. Why? Without mining, without agriculture, nothing will survive. So, why there is no opportunity? Just because I think it's a lack of competition and it's because of lack of appreciation based by the industry people that how a mining engineer can help us, how a metallurgy engineer can help us in having more business. Here we means when you talk, if the mining engineers they talk with metallurgists. Metallurgy engineers are treated as junior partner, by the way. जैसे मेरे को उसकी इंजीनियर लोग क्लास में बात करते हैं सो व्हाट आर द रिस्पांसिबिलिटीज ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटीज लाइक प्रोड्यूस ट्रेन मैन पावर विद साउंड कोर्स करिकुलम वी शुड हैव मेटलर्जी मेटल इकोनॉमिक्स एनवायरमेंटल इश्यूज पार्टिकुलर टेक्नोलॉजी फ्लूइड डायनेमिक्स पार्ट मटेरियल हैंडलिंग मटेरियल साइंस इवन इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन कंप्यूटर साइंस सॉफ्टवेयर राइटिंग ऑल दिस शुड बी Now, so research focus at university funding should be develop fundamental models for different techniques. Develop simulation packages for forecasting new ores and new unit operations. Design new mining and processing methods to utilize alternate mineral resources. Use technologies like video conferencing systems to operate streams or mines at remote location. That will educate them. If you educate your, say, you means here the faculties, you know. We must try to educate the industry people, that is the value in the process. Then only they will be able to appreciate your talent or your speed. That is also a problem here. So, conclusions. Mineral industry needs to address technical, economical and environmental issues simultaneously. It is not that our pollution control board will say that if you are polluting water, you have to do it. No, it should be in the culture. It should be automatic. Why somebody has to force me? It's our environment. Why don't we develop technology? Why don't we have our industry at the planning stages that we take care of this? That is my view. That why it should be told by someone. Industries and government agencies should foster the business support. Long-term planning and vision is crucial for interposed industry to survive and sustain the ever-increasing pressures. Contributions from other disciplines are necessary to make interposed a true engineering discipline. It's very easy to say, but you have to show them what is the value. That is, if they are putting their time into this, you have to show them that what they will get in the future. So you have to show that value. Mining and metallurgical engineers must realize the importance of the mineral engineers and should give them equal status at least in the entire metal extraction chain. That is my humble request. Okay, and nobody will give you this. You have to acquire. You have to prove it that. If we are not there, if they not run your show, nobody will give you a press. You have to act like that. So, thank you, Foundation.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, given a very elaborate sir, very nice sir. Very nice. Most of the students are one of the academic students. So, if any queries there from that side, they can ask.
I had a 3.5 hours interaction yesterday. Yes. So now also if you have any question, you can ask it. Maybe the mining engineers or other engineers who are sitting here, you can ask them. Yeah.
Thank you.
Get it from the
because what I am telling you is my experience. Because that I went somewhere else and I have done a job, I have posted there, then I came back and I have completed. But I have qualified in postal level geology. Then we can take a geospatial and remote sourcing. PhD in geophysics. Now I am working in geology and environment. Before that I was a scientist. Now in industry. Now I am a pilot. So whenever you will take a different angle, your research will grow, your output will grow, you will focus to one place, then you will find out the lacuna. Actually, whenever any research, any development, any work in industry also is very challenging. And for challenging, you will find out the objective. But the objective solutions everywhere. But getting the objective, getting the lacuna, it is very difficult. If you get the lacuna, if you get the objective, definitely solution will come. But getting this one in the industry, in the research institute, in the academy, it is very hard work, and I hope this seminar is very appreciated for the students. And this is also the lesson seminar, but already I have given the word of 30 years on the competition. Wouldn't that have found out this talking of accumulation of the students and interest of the students, particularly in the remote area, and in the past circumstances there, and it is inclusive for the researchers and academy. And our approaches to the government are going to be encouraged to the students to take it in different areas and different areas in one answer. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Do you have one question? Is there any more than
one.
First of all, I very much thank you for the excellent presentation.
Thank you.
I have a small question. Ultimate mind,
the conventional mind.
What is the role of copper in mine? That is the chapter by XCAPS. So there you use the bacteria like harvesters, peroxidase, which basically oxidizes the sulfur. And when the sulfur is oxidized, your copper and iron bonding is loosened up. And then you can extract by leaching process the copper. So you are not mining, you are just drilling and then injecting those things, and you are inculcating the growth of the bacteria. About mining, I think, so that will be. Is that the answer for the question for bacterial thing? So here the challenge is that for bacteria is that, that is, you need to interact with particles. That is, what type of bacteria? Maybe we have to culture new bacteria. Okay, that is the future, because I have a slide, you know, what I normally give the introduction to the person when I talk to the industry. I show that these are the future miners, that is the bacteria. I show that. So they are going to the future miners. You are probably not allowed to mine because of environmental restrictions and energy costs and all this. That is probably one of the. But in India, unfortunately, not much research is going on. Only Professor Nagarajan in IIT Bangalore, he was doing this research on biology, and some work was going on in IIT, but that gentleman has retired. After that, it has gone out again. So we have to work in that area. About future of mining, you know, I keep telling to my students that we must start working on how do I mine from the tailing ponds. Say tailing ponds could be my reserve for future. Whatever I'm doing today, that could be my resource. And it is going to be within 50-20 years. Now think of the tailing ponds. First thing is that how do I do sampling? So they are like we said, how do I approach? How do I go? How do I know what is the grade of that? Sampling. And if I have to mine from tailing pond, I don't need plastic. I don't need ventilation. I don't need probably rock mechanics, because they are already fine powder. What do we need? Probably we need more of fluid mechanics, because we may have to fluidize it much more and we have to pump it. So slurry pumping, pipeline transportation, all these things. So we must start doing this. Australia has already started. So what will happen? After 20 years, we face the problem with the technology for Australia. Why we are not coming out with this type of technology? But now it's the mindset problem. With the academicians, no, we have to solve industry problem. Industry problem is at present what they are facing. Because academicians are compelled by the your financial support. If we go to the industry and say, अरे भाई उसको लेके आप लोग मना भी कर रहे हो, एक बार अपने भाई का हमारा दिल दिमाग खा रहे हैं, आप भी बोल रहे हो उसको लेके माइनिंग करो, उसका टेक्नोलॉजी इतनी करो, नॉबडी इज वॉन्ट्स, दैट इज अ माइंडसेट प्रॉब्लम फॉर पीपल आर देयर. मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर्स, सिविल इंजीनियर्स, माइनिंग इंजीनियर्स, दे वर्क टुगेदर, वी कैन डेफिनेटली डेवलप टेक्नोलॉजीज, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली वी आर नॉट इन दैट माइंडसेट प्रॉब्लम. यू नो इंडस्ट्री एकेडमिया इज इन द माइंडसेट प्रॉब्लम. वी एकेडमिशियंस वर्क इन आइसोलेशन. यू आस्क एनी प्रोफेसर इन आईआईटी, including me, including Dr. Bharma, other professors, most of us either we are working in a single person or maybe another person. We cannot develop technology one or two persons' job, it's not there. We cannot. We have to work in a team. That unfortunately we have not learned how to work in a team. The people who give us promotions, they ask, what is your contribution? There is no team like your group promotion. If you have developed the technology, you promote everyone. But the scheme is not there. So, entirely, you know, the system has to change.
The rabbit woke up and realized that he lost the race. The moral of the story is that slow and steady wins the race. This is the version of the story that we've all grown up with. Our version of the story continues. For quite a bit, was he disappointed at losing the race, and he did some thinking. He realized that he lost the race only because he had been overconfident, careless, and lax. If he had not taken things for granted, there is no way the turtle could have been on himself. He challenged the turtle to another race. The turtle agreed. This time, the rabbit went all out and ran without stopping from start to finish. He won by several miles. The moral of the story, fast and consistent will always be the slowest step.
$110 million. by 1920, we had challenges to achieve around 1,000 tickets of coal by Coal India and 1,500 by Coal India. So, challenges for us emerged. So, few challenges are just ignored. This is the link. Just I can answer some of the questions Mr. Sahu has raised, but there is no time. I dealt all these things in our company. I am looking after the forest, land, environmental, and able to submit the settlement. So on land, there are three types of land. But in MCR, we need 2 hectares of land for 1 million tons of production. So land, there are three types of land. This one is government land, another is tenancy land, third is the forest land. For government land, I think it is very easy. It is not so easy. Just to pay the premium and get the land, not by debt. Once the people have that, there is going to be some mine or some industry. Then people that they are just simply just thought that it is democratic and get on the settle and approach there. So it becomes more complex there. Then second is the first land. First land, then we can have there so much procedures we can have it. It is done on 4 years together. Men, harmful. Then it is. Police was NOC, there is now a rule, and this is 206-7-8. NOC you have to get a reject, but this is very complex process. The village are there, simply reject that thing. You must have hard road, memory, all these things, Ramaswa, they have failed like this. Now coming to this financial end, it is head of a phenomena. How to acquire this financial end? There is compensation, employment, resettlement. All this is a complex phenomenon. It is not so easy. But, sir, how if you listen, I can suggest some answer to your question. Is related to some resettlement. I'm just talking my. There are high principles to solve this RR issue. In our suggestion, we have some. This is my personal. Some group suggestion, that is the 5 hours of English. That is A is annuity. Annuity means people should get some sort of money regularly. Once they have made one compensation at a time, so they spend their purchase vehicle now, you have in Vasundhara area, some compensation paid, some 5 BMW vehicles are running. So they spend all of a sudden, they just work. So they should get this.
Now it's time for the hereditary session. Now I'd like to request our new principal, sir. Dr. S. C. Khatul, Dr. A. K. Patunga, Dr. S. K. Nair to come to the dais. Please, sir. Now I will request our principal sir to speak few words. Good evening to everyone. Good afternoon, we are having a little behind schedule, so let us make it very shorter. For the information, actually this institute, when I was born in March, 2nd of March, 2015. So the first day when I joined actually in Jaipur, I met some people, some people came to visit me, and Kiran sir is the first one who has come to this institute, and he and a team member actually they have come and met me. And before coming to this place, I was also not knowing what is the history of this institute, why, what is the basics of opening all these mineral, metallurgy and mining processes in this institute. So he has given me that insight, that it was as told in the beginning, that at the time Vice Chancellor was Dr. Omkaran Mahanti. And he wanted, because this is completely surrounded by all the mining industries and the mines. So let us make it a institute of art science which encompasses all the departments of mining engineering. So that's why it's a unique feature this institute has mineral engineering product. And for the information service, the first institute conference seminar we are organizing as a group of students of mining engineering and mineral engineering. I want to name one is Rohan from mining engineering, another is Chinmay from mineral engineering. They started meeting me since 3 months or 4 months back, and they told us, sir, let us start doing something like this. So we have started this process. Maybe we have considered this process 4 months back, but practically we have started this process only 1.5 months back. And I feel satisfied actually because we have been able to attract people from good institutes like NITs and IITs. We have been able to attract resource persons from good research institutes like IMIT and NML. We have been able to attract people from industries. So I feel satisfied that anyway, this is a small beginning. For your information, this conference hall actually is not. Yesterday night actually, I left this hall at 9 o'clock, but it was not completed. So, for information, the volunteers, I was away from Punjab last week for 45 days, and I was monitoring the progress of this mobile phone and the smartphones. Each and every component, like bottles of the color appears. Sunlight, Avita, Sunlight, repairing all these things, Rohan is giving me a WhatsApp file, confirming, okay, to go through it. So, in the last few days, we are working, and I hope that maybe in the near future, actually, the other objective is for this conducting seminar, that This time our university is going to have a new curriculum for this Bidra mining and metals department. Completely new curriculum. So maybe we can conduct another workshop in the very near future, within a month or 2 months. I have to invite the people who are really concerned about this industry and we can keep the feedback, what should be the curriculum of this mining and mineral engineering. And certainly this workshop will help us in formulating the people, the policy, and how to design this curriculum for this mineral industry. And I expect Professor Madhula, I'll be meeting you certainly in this chapter. And of course, people from industry, because they are quite busy, they are most of the people have read that we have to take our respect from this industry also for upgrading this curriculum. Because as we know, we have discussed throughout the day what are the challenges faced by mining industries and mineral industries. We had actually another discussion scheduled where we had to discuss, actually, we wanted to discuss the gate and the challenges. That means, as academicians, what we are teaching and industry, what is the requirement? And accordingly, you have found a policy document or something like that, but somehow, because of the paucity of time, we are not able to conduct that kind of discussions. But certainly, in future, sir, we want the help of from the research lab, from the IITs and MITs, so that they can populate this curriculum. And as I have said in the morning, actually, throughout the day, actually, most of the presentations from internal engineering are there. But when I'm moving to industry, actually, the last 1 and 1.5 months, I think my students actually moved to different industries nearby Kinshasa. Mining industries and mineral industries, and very few of them actually, I am speaking very few of the mining industry has been meter important to this mineral industries. So, suddenly we have to say, or we have to, as Professor Madhanbar has told, that the mineral engineering people will have to grab that prestige from this metal people and mining people. So this process will help us to do a lot of things with beginning, and we certainly conduct this type of process in the future. And as told, not only for mining and mineral engineering, we also we have very recently again we are planning a workshop by mechanical and metallurgy people, they combine together, they are planning in the month of November that is coming. And also another aspect, another workshop or whatever we say individuals, we are inviting mostly people from industries and the HR people so that they can enlighten our students what is the requirement of industries and how we can our voice. We should pitch what we should learn in these 4 periods so that we can employ the private industry. Industry people will not say that as many of his delegates have told that when our students go to industry, they have to compare actually that the students doesn't have the basics of the industrial practices. So certainly we are inviting in only that we specify for the industry, only we are inviting industry people to have interactions with the students so that the students can get a grasp of what is the requirement of these industries. So thank you all, sir. Thank you all. All thank you all. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to invite Dr. H.P. Nair to summarize the event.
Good evening, everyone. It was a very nice day today. All of us have ventured today with good technical input from various experts present today. This seminar was the challenges in mining and mineral industry, and the government engineering college came to. They have rightly chosen the topic, and today the experts they have clearly talked about it. And this, to my view, this seminar will be a great success because I found all have taken quite keen interest to take part in this deliberation. And from the very start of the day,
we have dealt in greater detail about the minerals processing and the beneficiation and the retention and burner. When we go back to 20 years back, Dr. Mazumdar is here, mineral engineering aspects, he must be knowing. When I was a student, I was taking training at Mahamuthi Aerial Mines. And he was just in our 30 years back, in 1982. When I was taking training at Mahamuthi Aerial Mines, I found that a lot of brooders, lot of these mines are accumulated in the mines. And it was a great moderation for the mining engineers because they were treating them as waste materials. Because the blue dust and the fines which are produced in the mines because of the poor design of the blasting and other problems. So it is accumulated day by day and it is a great waste for the nation because they often pay high grade iron ores. But there is no use because of the steel plant or any steel plant. They need a particular kind of material. So, day by day, the mineral engineers, they develop the technology and they went forward by doing research and a lot of innovation. And they try to utilize waste retention and filtering and so many other methods they have developed. Today, whatever Dr. S.K. Vishwa was speaking about, so the scientific engineers, they think much ahead the problem. So this is a good conglomeration of the scientists where the problems are there, challenges are there, what we have to get it. For that reason, this type of seminars are definitely eye openers and people are there thinking about the topic today. And the problems are there, and we have to find out solutions for sustainable mining practices, taking care, due care to the ecology and environment as Mr. Star has shown. Because he is the man of this area, and Kevja is the heart of mining activities, which is the attention of whole nation, not only Odisha. Whole nations are lying on Kevja because of high level iron ores are there, and the India. Industrial development depends on the chemical development, as it is said rightly. But the people, the CSR, other activities, maintained, agriculture, and mining were made, but the people who are living in the land, they should also get the benefits. So that everything should be there. So, anyway, those things are. Not covered in this seminar, but mostly the people have dealt about our own field, the iron ore, because it's the iron ore field. So I am very happy that people have spoken about the iron ore and the activities going on in the outer place, particularly in this field. And definitely, this type of deliberation seminar conference. To the students, particularly students, they must have enjoyed our school, they must have known what are the things going on in this locality. And the government has rightly chosen this place and for establishing this institute as a mining, mineral and metallurgy institute because it is surrounded by mining activities, mining companies. So, a lot of mining companies are there too. So, definitely, this department has grown from 10 to 10. In the past, conference we have collected, but I am sure in the near future, many more bigger conferences will be conducted in this day. And I am happy that the ambience, the atmosphere is very good, conducive for further growth. And I wish, I pray, Almighty that this institute will grow further. And we enjoy the fruits from this institute. Thank you.
Now, I'd like to request Dr. Kelsey Kuhn. Sorry, to give some more.
head comes first. Delegate from the dais, of the dais. Teachers, my dear students. I think you must have lost your patience by now to listen to any more. But I will first tell you, your leaders and yourself, pat your back. First time doing it so successfully. Good job. Is one of the leading brands today. I remember long back, in first year it was opened. One of my friends called from Bhubaneswar, that is for the president of Andrology and other branches. What he should do, I told him, first, get her through Andrology and start the first class student here. Because this is the future, you must know this is the future. And out of the all presentation, I think my presentation was related to mining, mineralogy and metallurgy. It's a combination presentation, but there was no time today. Since I am available, I can always present you any content and I follow the principle of the same thing. So delete me. Because we must hear to the other people, not come from the distance. Because I am available, so whatever is possible, I can talk to you. And next is what? Dr. Vajan Daya, he must have charged you. What's your? Okay. So that is what he should carry forward. And he has made that creative mind think out of box. That is most important. And this question of knowing good mechanics or something. And how things work, asking the question why, how it works. He has ignited your mind and you must walk in that direction. Well, I can understand that the thing what he has told it should be combination mechanical, should be combination of your technology, metallurgy, everything. Because since I am from mechanical, worked 30 years in industries, my background was in designing metal. And I did my PhD in metallurgy. So I see all the things what he has told is very correct. And he also know a little of everything. Some of your students went to me when this function planning was going there. I have also told the same thing. That we have to know. Otherwise, we will not able to succeed. Because today, assistant Dr. Bishwar and I am MD are on this ground specifically. Whenever the process is being developed and designing of that part, because I understand both the things, metallurgy and metallurgy, and being a mechanical design, so many things, it's perfect match, and this is what I'm going to explain to Dr. Mazumdar also. So that is what we are trying to get in the beginning, but anyway, after this also, set up. Okay, that's what I'm about. So, the other part what we told, when I was doing my PhD work, my professor initially told, anything I am telling you, you are always extending to the industry. You will never have to complete your industry. So, if I just produce papers, what is the point? If it cannot utilize in the industry. So, not really by the time I complete it, we have innovated and patented and made one process of metallurgical, which is a tunnel kiln, and using your fines, and other fines, control fines. And working successfully for the last 2 years. So that is what you can know that it is bigger. And fortunately today, scholars are great and they are also going in the same direction. So, my dear students, as he has told you rightly, you have to, you are rightly positioned, right branch. And if you really want to succeed, it will be a great success of yours.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, sir. Now, I'd like to invite you to begin. Questions or doubts are there, they can ask for the any questions?
Thank you.
questions. Say, there is no question in the R2 which is called stupid question. No question is stupid question. Question is question.
I have a question for Kugya sir. Sir, it is quite a notion that countries like China and America can also get a lot of coal reserves, but they are not exploring it with the intention that in future when the market goes down, they will try to sell that coal at unpaid prices. Is India not in a position to do that countries like China and America can get a lot of coal reserves? Why can't India adopt that?
It's not like that. Actually, in China, they are studying their SEO and they are going to attack over. Recently, I have been to China and I have seen there that they are, the situation is like not like India. They are hungry for to work. They want to work more and earn more. And India and India work with one clock, but they have work. That is different. So, there is, we are unable to produce. Actually, we are trying to produce. We are trying I told you some constraints, but now we can produce, but some constraints are there. The infrastructure is not adequate. From Kanpur to this Talzer, only single line. So we are having inadequate infrastructure. But there they have a developed infrastructure. China recently, within 25 years, they have developed so much. I have been recently been to China, last year. I have seen China.
The dependency on the coal is number one reason behind India. We are highly dependent on the coal, but we produce more. Don't you think it is a big deal? Our sector produce less, and then the other companies are very dependent on the coal. Others, presently, this coal is most valuable energy source of India. Others means currently, then means non-valuable. To larger extent, to different large scale, they are non-valuable, but we are switching over to other means of power, hydropower, solar power, etc. Our MCL, though we are producing 2 megawatt solar power.
Regarding this use of coal, the first is that your cost of energy, till today, whatever the technology is available, the power unit cost of energy produced by the coal mine is the cheapest. Now, problem is that, okay, wind energy, where will we get? As long as the cost of energy is, the capacity is less. Solar energy, problem is with the electronics and material sciences for people that we don't know how to get a economically viable solar cells. You know? That is the problem. Then you're with climatic condition variations. How will you be able to supply consistent, say, to your the consistent requirement of your energy to the industry and to the domestic purpose? About the coal production, you know, sir, I work also in the area of coal washing. A couple of weeks back, I was in your colleague at head office with your PSP chairman and your CP, Mr. Yavai. We are discussing some confidential project. I cannot discuss that here. I can discuss with you personally. There, I just asked them that Coal India has decided by 2020. They will try to double the production at 1 billion. I asked them that, have you thought about the transportation of that coal? Have you spoken to railways? Whether they will lay down more railway tracks? Have you talked about the national highway option? Whether they will have more roads? Or have you thought about alternate mode of transportation? Then I say, have you talked to NTPC or other power generating sectors that whether they will be able to expand their facilities? So they must be a consumer. You are a producer, a rural consumer. And after all, whether our industrial growth is such like that, that we will be able to consume even the energy you are able to produce, the excess of energy you are able to do. Have you spoken to the Typhap or other industries that whether we have got technologies to deal with the fires? The fires, whatever we generate, what we are going to do? Who will give me the land to dispose of my fires if we don't use them? So, we should not think of only production. That is what you are saying, that I look at it in a different dimension. And then the DSP chairman said that we are going to conduct one workshop with some attendees from say regular institutes and from other partners, CTPC and all this. You know. So this is what I'm trying to say, that we should keep the entire. So this is not only the simply the production or alternative method. Alternative is fine, but it has to be cost effective. This argument is business. What is not cost effective? Nobody is going to buy it. Okay. I hope it answers.
I have to ask you. By more and more increasing in industries, hedges and cotton fields. But actually, sir, I have read in one magazine that in our coal block, our natural burning under the earth crust, which is the major purchase of global warming in India and in other countries. So, what are the precautions at the end? About this matter. Actually, it is the very important process of global warming. What are the questions?
Actually, we are cutting trees. But you are not knowing that.
No.
I am answering your question. Mathematically, we are producing twice per area whatever we crop. You might not be knowing that we pay the global whatever forest area we divert, we pay for the creation of the global area of the forest area. Apart from this, we, for environmental purpose, this mineral area, actual area, we can separate. Means we are creating threefold forest. So, mathematically, after this, we generally, this rural agency, we divide the money, one is called Gamba Fund, twice the area. Are you understanding? So mathematically we are producing double the forest area. So it is the duty of the government to prevent this, so the forest area is created.
No, sir, this is not my question. Actually, what happened in coal block?
See, actually, let me tell you, I don't know what is the source from where you got. You are talking about spontaneous burning of fire.
Yes, yes.
Your energy available in the source of
So I don't know what is the source, so you check the source, like Wikipedia you have seen it. Yeah, and then many industries are there, we are running our business even what Mr. Ricky Rao was telling, that was by the Volkswagen. I drive a Volkswagen. Volkswagen people, they have basically tampered the they have something the electronic circuit to bring back the environmental norms, you know, and then one US scientist reported that you are basically tampering. So now they are in deep trouble. So basically our vehicles, when we are driving, you know, a single man including me, which has got the capacity of 5 people, most of the time I am driving alone. This is not a loss, so I am polluting. But is there any alternate mode of comfortable transport? I don't have. So what I can do? We are hanging here.
This is not what we are making in the
everything, you know, the population growth. More population, more oxygen and more carbon dioxide you are in it. It's all related.
Hello, Mr.
See, actually, Delhi is come to consider to be one of the most polluted cities in the world. I mean, proper Delhi, not many industries are there. That is the outskirts. The main pollution is coming from Baker.
Sir, another question is, how the time of Digital India? And sir, so what are the model digital processes? And digital processes or digital processes and software are using in the challenges of mining and mineralization? Because today our Prime Minister is India, Digital India, Digital India. So what are the digital processes and softwares are using challenges mining and mineral resources?
So mining is
actually, almost today I am unable to give messages, so that is related to my business also. That is what is that geo economy. Now, the geo economics are such a where the subsurface and surface features will identify by the different images. And that images are coming from the different geo satellites. Now, the worldwide all also comes from the satellites. Because the satellites basically radar data and so, radar, microbes, they will find out the deepest subsurface features, subsurface images without any hurdles, any climate condition, any situation, any events. This image are coming whenever overlapping and intermittent of the image. So, this is the image, the features and information are coming, and lot of interesting subjects are also asking that. And they are getting a lot of sound from them. So now India also, so very seriously. This is also digital image.
Not here, right? Like whatever works you are doing in mining communication office.
Just with phone calls, you are doing all the work. Whatever the data are there, all are different companies. Like retiring from the radar and all that. Surveying cost, everything is done to business. So there is no physical business at all. Everything is being done by the running suit. So this is not the digital age. You know, nothing is there on the pay and paper. Like you are getting your salary. No salary is received from. Everything, all the money will be transferred to your bank account. So nothing is there. This is not the digital age. Money transfer, like ATM, getting everything through your credit card or ATM card.
This is probably because of the sectors on it.
I am from the industry digital banking unit. There are many people who are looking for a lot of people who are in the industry. So we have a lot of people who are in the industry. So now we are going to have a CBS chat. We are going to have a CBS chat. Hello. We are going to go out with CBS. Essentially, the control.
Industry will come and take me.
I think the first thing I learned since I'm out from the industry.
When you go for any interview, they don't ask questions from your book. They'll ask you practical questions. And you should have that exposure to that. So, looking that you had some studying in IMJ, you have seen some improvements and all. So, that's the recipe you will want to fix up some improvement here where you can do the test and on improvement and testing. So that your confidence level will go up and you will understand what you are doing. As long as you read from the book, at least you will be able to get the feel of it. So once you have that confidence, automatically in the people in the mind, industry, they will ask that how much you can deliver. When they know that yes, because of the capability you have done it, you are capable of doing it, suddenly they will think. That will be the first point I will take. Any other point you want to ask? But that is the first thing. Every industry always asks practical questions, and if you are not able to, because normally when we ask questions that we are seeing, students ask speaking from the book, and then you are just like there is like a training. Then they have to spend many more time and money on you to develop you to come to that skill. But before you go out of your institute, you have that skill. Your potential of growing up will be much, much higher.
In continuation with Dr. Bhavai, I want to specifically for this person, I'm going to give a half and then for your information, sir. After I joined already one day industrial visit of federal already completed, or five completed. Another 5 is coming up, and I think most of the industries have given a ready consensus to, you can say, the first and training, or at least for one day. The students have visited, Minerva Engineering students have visited recently to OCS, the mines. Mining engineering students are visiting Coal India and Global Coal. Mineral students are visiting Global Coal. Some students are electrical and mechanical students are visiting the nearby industries like NIML, CSL, Invalco. So we have taken an initiative and for those students, what I get this take is that before going for the industrial visit, and the first thing is that some of the students are going to their websites, preparing their slides, so that the students can get a free information that what they are going to visit, what learning they will come. And that presentation was given before these students actually visit the industries. And what you are trying, summer internship is not matter very much, many of our students are going to industries, but in a very humble way. So, from this next session, what we are trying to do is that each and every student will visit the industry. And our training and placement department will take the initiative, we will contact all these industries before the students go, and we will get the concept of the industries and we will visit our students. But some of the options that we gave from the industries also, recently I have met some people from different industries also. Their feeling is that your students are coming on the first day, and on the last day they get the certificates or something like that. So, as Professor Bhavai is told, that for employability, you have to have that first-hand experience of any industries. So this one-month industrial training during these vacations, of course, many of you are in the final year, so you may not get a chance. But the students who are in the second year and third year level, you must have this one-month industrial training and try to learn each and everything the industry requires from it. And for your information, sir, what we are making is industrial visit also. Suppose for mining students, we have observed that they require a visit to open cast mining, they require a visit to your deep coal mining, they require a visit to a farm, a visit now recently to this sand mining, to IIL. So whatever mines, they will be employed maybe after the graduation. So we are planning in such a way that the students may pass out must have visited at least one time to one of these mines. Similarly, for middle students also, we have planned in such a way that we must have visited a coal washery, we must have visited a, beneficiation farm like this. And I request all my students here, when you are going for this visit, actually, don't, it's not a specific trip. It's a learning trip for all of you. Take it very seriously. Try to interact with the persons from the industries and try to get something. You can say, yes, we have this lab, it's small instruments, but when you go to the industry, it's a large instrument, isn't it? So try, the scale is not quite large. So try to learn during this industrial visit, maybe for one day, and during this, you can see results in the meditation. And certainly it will help you to improve your employability. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. You said very good step has been taken by the principal. You all people are going to industry. But be serious in that, because as he said, it won't make it picnic. First of all, you have come to higher year. Tomorrow, let's say, you get the opportunity for the interview. The person who will interview will ask what you are seeing, how the printer works, where the pump is situated, how it is pumping to the funnel, what is being separated there. And if you have not really thought and seen those things, you are not able to answer and you will start blocking, then you will get eliminated. So be serious, don't take it as a big thing. Because this is your requirement to learn. And since you have given the opportunity, it's a very good thing, very good step, second by thing. And you have to really utilize that problem.
I am telling from the student side, this industrial tool for one day is okay, but during the summer course, what student has difficulty, I want to just highlight. At least this, all the mining area, obviously remote area, many industries that would provide the accommodation. So, the general feeling is that you just spend one or 2 days and just go away and come back and take this certificate. Ask our principal to take this matter that the commercial is being provided to the students during this vacation. I think some of the industries also are providing the information, but somehow not all the industries. So we will take your advice and we will initiate the process of asking all these industries to provide the information during this summer. Thank you, sir.
I have done my experience. Is I have taken travel in Mount Yalamai, they have provided accommodation, and this Hindustan Copper, Artina, they have provided accommodation. And our own company, where I am now working, is Coal India, they have not given us accommodation. And it is mostly in our Coal India. I have honestly admitted.
I'm looking after the training placement of our department. And this is a big problem in our all the platforms. Because we are dealing with the bad register, I'm not making it at present. But as you said, two companies are getting, I will not hesitate to name them, like Tata Steel, Israel, then NMDC sometimes. It is very few numbers are there. They are providing that, the life that scale is providing. But Coal India, very few. If you have some alumni base, you can contact the alumni and request them. Possibly they will provide you all the ingredient box. Senior is there, they can accurately support for it. So this kind of thing is there, but very few accommodations. So what I have asked is how much money you are spending for accommodation. Accommodation is also issue, transportation is the issue, and food is also issue. Are there. So, people are spending about 400 or 10,000 for their accommodation, putting as well as sometimes they are taking transportation to 10 kilometers away. So, this is a challenge as far as the industry is concerned. So, sometimes what happens, part of the mining industry, we are the part of the new things coming out in IIT system, not only IIT Kharagpur. In other ideas also, that's why we are going for this industrial training. These ideas are now asking for some sort of project, industrial based project, so these students can work with the research by taking all the dollars from the industry. So this is what some of the students are going to come. And as you were saying, students are going for the first day and collecting the certificate on the last day. the manager is very strict, sometimes he will compel you to come for all the 30 days. Then what he will give you the certificate. This situation is also there, but definitely we should get some provision so that this type of problems can be solved. This is really a problem.
Actually, whatever I have told about whole India, it is wrong here. I have also in Dubai street, I have gone to whole India. They have given me accommodation. It is the government of students. They are giving whatever the एग्जीक्यूटिव क्वार्टर मुझे दिया गया था इसीएल बट द प्रॉब्लम इज अस वी आर क्रिएटिंग सम काइंड ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम सो दैट वन पर्सन ओनली ऑल आर बीइंग नॉट गिवन द रूम सो वी मस्ट लुक अवर दैट हम लोग जैसे प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट करते हैं बट वो इंडिया से मेंटेनिंग नहीं हो तो सेकंड क्लास इवन एमसीएल से सब कुछ को रिजेक्ट कर सकते हैं बट वो लिखे तो नहीं कर रहा है थोड़ा बहुत हम लोग का ट्रेनिंग का प्रॉब्लम है तो अंडरग्राउंड का ट्रेनिंग के लिए वो लिखे कौन मिल जाए हम लोग नहीं है हम लोग इसके बारे में डिस्कस करना चाहिए हम लोग को थ्री टू फोर इयर्स के बारे में हम लोग ये रूम फैसिलिटी क्या थिंग जो कि जरूरत हम लोग का है हम लोग का मेन है वो लिखे का अंडरग्राउंड ट्रेनिंग और सेकंड क्लास का क्लास्टर ये बस डिस्कस और दैट हम लोग को जैसे ट्रेनिंग के लिए देना चाहिए उसके बारे में वो पूछा था हम लोग को पार्टी वगैरह
सर एक्चुअली व्हेन आई रेज दैट क्वेश्चन आई हैड अ डिफरेंट इंटेंशन इन माय माइंड दैट आई वांट टू गो टू द डायरेक्टर व्हाई आई ट्राई टू से द प्रिंसिपल हैज सेड आई थिंक दैट्स नॉट एनफ दैट इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट आफ्टर कमिंग हियर टुडे I think even every year in IIT Kharagpur we organize some student conference. I have not seen during my last 5 years that so many industry people are there. Even in IIT Kharagpur, they try. But I'm really glad this is the first occasion and the first So what I am requesting the principal that to explore it in a different way. Like So when you have got so much of attention and those bells with the local industries, like you have got this house of 40 million units. This house of I say that I will develop an expertise in traffic. You talk to the industries, you put them in that industry for 1 month, 5 people, accommodation everyone will provide. And ask them to follow that how to operate the cluster business plan. And then next year, because when you are operating, you know what are the problems. Next year, let them go to a research laboratory and try to innovate something or maybe try to work in the laboratory in a systematic manner, then why it happens and all. So when you pass out, you can say that I am an industrial engineer, but I have got this business background. So when you So target the CASA manufacturers and all this, they to get departmental support. Like competitions are being grabbed. Seeing a total industry, even in 1 month, you don't understand anything. You go there, operate it, put them, say, convince them that your students will be serious. So if we do that, if we are distributing the 60 students in an exciting 20 industries, everyone will be able to provide accommodations and all this. And then the business also will come up, and I think your employability also will go up. That is what I think, but I don't know whether it is possible. Because in IIT it is difficult, because most of our students, their mindset is that by joining mining industry is my last option. So we cannot deny that we are not in a mining field. We don't have, we are not surrounded by local industries there. It is our locational problem also. But if you are really blessed with this location, why don't you use that?
Thank you, sir. Please, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Actually, from that, what industry? We are talking about 4 million people. There is an open class map. We are unable from Singapore side and this black group side, we are unable to get the GEP or MP or screen. Now we have just enrolled in Satyagraha to the government more and more time. That is poor industry. There must be something on the government side and all the senior retired. I request that the training should be given to all the industry, all the degrees here, but it's about that planning and program. Because we are thinking, why should we carry a small tube carrier? Why should we small carrier for a 9-star person in the open class? We must take the agriculture in. Because I know, because I cannot blame coal in India, because I have got everything about the FGM. Yes.
You know, now I would like to request Mr. Somanandan Malik to keep the vote of thanks. Good evening to all of you.
For inviting us to be a part of this nice gap and have a good interaction with the student. And thank you very much. If you have any problem, you are free to contact us. You are very good.
Ji, again, the mic is here.
I want to thank to all our distinguished guests, keynote speakers, delegates, others the college speakers, business scholars, participants, students of this college for participating in this national seminar on challenges in mining and mineral industries in CMMI 2015. I would like to express my thanks to our alumni association, particularly our president of this alumni association for his tremendous support. Lastly, I thank all members. Lastly, I thank all members of organizing committee, my chairman colleagues, all the students of this institute who have been involved for this particular event for last several weeks. Without their professional support, we could have made it to that possible. It was really a productive discussion, and I think it will immensely help the body engineers of this college. I am confident that this national seminar, CMMI 2015, would be of immense help to the practicing engineers, academicians, scientists, body engineers, students of this institute, research scholars who have contributed their papers in this seminar. Would be of immense help, and I declare this national seminar on the challenges in mining and mineral industry CMMI 2015 closed. Thank you.